That's it. Good evening, everyone. Thank you all for coming out this evening. Happy New Year to everybody. We're going to begin our board meeting. I would like to call to order the regular meeting of the Board of Trustees. Today is January 2nd, 2024, and the time is 6:52 p.m. Clerk, can you call the roll?
It's 6:55 p.m. Correction, 6:55. Can you guys hear me? Is my mic on? Can you hear me now? Okay, great. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Trustee Norwood. Trustee Stan Brown. Trustee Tammy Brown. Present. Trustee House.
Here.
Trustee Holmes.
Here.
Trustee Belcher.
Here.
We have a quorum.
All right, next, if you all stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. If we could, we're going to have Trustee Tammy Brown lead us in prayer.
Father, we thank you for this gathering tonight, and we hope that your work and your will be done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 All right, next we have public comment, and then after public comment, we will do the swearing in of our police officers and also our engineer for the fire department. So you have 3 minutes to address the body. If you would like to speak or say anything, please come to the podium. You have 3 minutes. All right, hearing none. Next, we are going to start with the swearing in so we can get you guys out of here. I want you to sit through a long, drawn-out board meeting. So we're going to start with the swearing in. Here we go. Testing, testing. All right, y'all make some noise for our fire department and our police department. Y'all give it up for y'all. Congratulations, everybody. Congratulations. Okay, first we're going to start with the fire department. So if I can have the new fire engineer up. Ready?
Mr. Edwin Knoblich.
Come on down. Congratulations. All right. You want that side? What's that?
His wife will be pinning him.
Be in the middle. Yep. All right. Congratulations again. I know you worked hard for this. I know you was waiting for your promotion. So I just want to say thank you for your commitment to the Village of Dalton and our residents and our Board of Trustees. We appreciate all that you give up for us. Public safety is a hard position. So we just thank you for that. All right. So raise your right hand. Repeat after me, but you're going to say your name. So I... No. Okay. Yeah. It's okay. It's okay. Okay. We'll start over. It's okay. It's okay. Congratulations. Okay. Hi. Did say your name. Having been appointed to the office of fire engineer in the Village of Dalton in the County of Cook, do solely swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of Illinois, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of fire engineer for the Village of Dalton to the best of my ability. Congratulations. It's okay. Yeah. All right. Congratulations once again. Take a photo. All right, thank you. Next, we have police sergeants. Anybody that just passed a test, come on up. So proud of you. Come on up. So proud of y'all. So we're going to do it as a group, just so we clear for the residents so you understand what's going on. I'm going to say I, then each of you will say your name thereafter, and we're going to swear them in. They passed their test. So let's make some noise just for passing your test. I know that was hard. Congratulations. Yeah. All right. So here we go. You got anything?
No, I'll say them later.
Okay. So raise your right hand. Okay. Now I, say your name.
Hi, Marissa Curry.
Hi, Terry Young Jr.
Mike Yoholi.
Vincent Nunez.
All right. Give y'all make some noise just for that. having been appointed to the office of police sergeant in the village of Dalton in the county of Cook, do solely swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States in the Constitution of the state of Illinois, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of police sergeant for the village of Dalton to the best of my ability. Congratulations.
Would the families who are going to be pinning their loved ones come up, please?
Sergeant, what? James, can you come and get photos, please? Congratulations.
Okay. All right. I you know what? I wasn't going to say anything, but I'm going to say this. I am so proud of these guys. When I say that they get out there and they do what they're supposed to do to serve the Dalton, they do it. So I'm very proud to promote them today with the leadership of the mayor. And guess what? Y'all working now.
Yeah, come on, guests. Congratulations. All right, next we have police lieutenant. Come on.
It's a long time coming, boy.
Man, just to give you a little history about a lot of them and me, meaning the police officers, a lot of them saw me grow up from literally a teenage to the person I am today. I've been booted and rooted in this community forever, and so have them. Some of them got 20 plus years, and we've been running the streets forever. So I love y'all just for y'all commitment and just staying on board and staying focused. So I appreciate that, because it takes a lot for somebody to run towards bullets when we all running from them. So thank you guys for your service. Thank you. Right. You ready? It's the same thing. So you repeat after me. When I say I, you're going to state your name. So here we go. I,
Michelle Staples.
Marlon Harris.
Eric Price.
Okay. Having been appointed to the office of police lieutenant in the village of Dalton in the county of Cook, do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of Illinois, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of police lieutenant for the village of Dalton to the best of my ability. Congratulations.
All right, it's going to be the same thing. For those family members that are going to do the pinning of the new lieutenants, can you please come up, please?
Come on, Commander. See, leave it to the youth. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Yeah, you got help. Hey, let's get in here.
All right, y'all make some noise for him. Congratulations.
No, stand right there.
Sergeants, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce to you the new command staff for the Dalton Police Department, who is proud to serve you. I want to thank you for trusting us. I want to thank you for being there for us. I want to thank the administration for being there for us. Guess what? These are the ones, and we want to say thank you. Guys, thank you for your commitment.
All right. Okay, so don't leave yet. We got one more we got to do. Go ahead and see.
Sergeants, lieutenants. Okay.
So one big thing. We're gonna do a big
photo real quick. John and Ed, bring up the side right here. Sit down. All right. Congratulations, everybody.
Right there for 1 minute. Stan, did you want to get a photo? Or Drew? Any of y'all? Okay.
Y'all come.
All right, one more, James.
Yeah. All right, so y'all don't leave yet. We got one more of your brothers that we got to swear in. Okay? All right. You ready for the Okay. I have Malone.
Okay, we have one more special police officer. I would like to give a special shout out to Chief Lacey. I appreciate you for everything you've done. We have one person that has now became a canine officer. Come on up. All right, which way? You know, yeah, put them over there. Yeah, over there. All right, so we have a new police officer. His name is Max. So you will see him on the streets. And today we're going to swear in Officer Max. So congratulations. Thank you for all you do. And thank you for the training that you went through to get your canine dog. Would you like to say any words?
No.
Okay, all right. All right. So we're going to try to do this. All right, here we go. Okay, Max, raise your right paw. And repeat after me. I, Max, woof, 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 Max, come on. having been appointed to the office of police K-9 officer in the village of Dalton in the county of Cook, do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the state of Illinois, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of police K-9 officer for the village of Dalton to the best of my ability. Congratulations, Max. Y'all get up for Max. Congratulations. Thank you.
All right. All right. So
you got on your lace.
All right. So you guys remember some time ago, Officer Malone, who is now a K-9 officer, left for training, and he was successful in his training along with his partner. Like the mayor said, they will be out there on the streets. We have a new K-9 officer out there, so they will be definitely diligent and aggressive in a good way. So that being said, you know what? I'm proud of K-9. I'm proud of the new sergeants and lieutenants. And guess what? Dalton Police Department is on the move.
We'll take a picture of our dog. Okay, James, you can get them. I'm not. Just insert me in the photo later. Right now. All right, congratulations. I think that is it for all of the promotions. So congratulations, y'all. Give everybody a round of applause. Thank you so much for everything.
For the sergeants, report to Commander Guest. Fellow lieutenants, report to me. All right.
And anybody that wants to leave, you can. We're going to start our board meeting. If you want to stay, you can as well. Thank you so much.
You see him? I said, you see him?
Attention. Hey, everybody, if you could, can you go to the right just so we can start our board meeting? If you would like to stay, you can. Thank you so much. Eat lots of pasta. Wherever y'all going to celebrate, thank you. Okay, so I just want to start the new year off the right way by just showing you things that we truly do here in the village of Dalton. Despite all the mess and the negativity you might see or hear, it's a lot of great things that get overshadowed by people just being negative. My goal is to try to make sure that everyone is always loved on, cared about, and make sure they know that I appreciate them, because at the end of the day, you don't know when is when. You don't even know if you would have woke up this morning. So you should be thankful for just seeing another day. And I just want to tell the residents of Dalton that I truly appreciate you, and you see that ain't no stopping us now. We on the move. So we're going to continue to do that. You see the promotions we did within the police department, which is public safety, which we truly, truly need here in the village, and also with our fire department. They've been waiting for a minute to do their promotions. So now everything is here, and you will see them on the streets, booted and rooted. And I just want to say again, I appreciate you for those that do take up a field in public safety. Next on the agenda is general announcements. Do anyone have any general announcements? Okay, go ahead.
Good evening. I just want to announce Tea with the Trustees is back up and running. The date for Tea with the Trustees is January the 13th, 9:30 a.m., 14700 Evers, and that's the Lester Long Fieldhouse, 9:30 a.m. Saturday. Thank you.
Is there anyone else?
Yeah,
go ahead.
Happy New Year, everyone. Happy Tuesday. I would just like to announce that I'm still going to host the annual skating party, family skate night. So that is a tentative date of February the 2nd. That's that Friday. It'll be from 6:30 to 9 o'clock p.m. So if you all, once I confirm the date, if you all are not following us on our Dalton Trustees YouTube page, please feel free to do so. Or feel free to email me at bnorwood@vodalton.org for more information. Thank you.
One more, Mayor. Can I please?
Go ahead.
Okay. I just wanted to announce, I'm sorry, the passing of Miss Cotton, who was the wife of Mr. Cotton, who passed away just a couple of weeks ago. Just got the announcement that Miss Cotton passed away, just got it right now that she passed away, and we will be updating everyone with the funeral arrangement, but no arrangements have been made so far. So yeah, just passed away, but she just came over that she passed away. Miss Cotton, the wife of Mr. Cotton, who worked for years and years for the Dalton Park District. Thank you for that.
All right, no problem. Anyone else?
I'd like to speak on something.
Sure, go ahead.
Oh, just to piggyback on that, Mr. Ms. Cotton, also residents in the village of Dalton. Boy, that's a loss. We just experienced a big loss. Ooh, man. Yeah. I'd just like to speak on, ladies and gentlemen, Township Talk. Supervisor Tiffany Hendon will be every fourth Wednesday of each month from 5 to 7 p.m. That will be held at Thorn Township in the lower level. Also, Thorn Township after school program Monday through Friday, 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. at Thorn Township Youth and Family Service Center, located at 14400 Halsted in Riverdale. Also, there's a computer lab also Monday through Friday, 9 to 3 at 14323 Halsted. Also, Thorn Township, if you need food, visit the food pantry, located at 15340 Page Avenue in Harvey, Illinois. That's every Wednesday from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. If you need assistance, Thorn Township, from the supervisor and board of trustees, for general assistance for qualified applicants, basic needs, utility assistance, mortgage assistance, burial assistance, mental health assistance. Mental health is on the rise, ladies and gentlemen. Let's utilize these programs that the township is offering. Also, if you're a resident of Thorn Township throughout the 17 municipalities, there's senior service transportation anywhere in Thorn Township, Monday through Friday, from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Call 708-596-6040, extension 4011. That's for transportation throughout Thorn Township, 708-596-6040, 40, extension 4011. Transportation throughout the township. Also, there's a super duper class they have going on at Thorn Township. Tech Savvy for seniors. 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. every fourth Thursday of each and every month at Thorn Township, 333 East 162nd Street. In the lower level, Tech Savvy for our seniors, whoever want to do the Facebook, text, email, and some other things that you can get to do on these little computer things that we have. And also, ladies and gentlemen, we just had an awesome, awesome, big, big, big bingo at Thorn Township. Actually, refrigerators, stoves, wash machines, and dryers were actually prizes being given out. Bingo is every third Thursday of each month from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. at Thorn Township, 333 East 162nd Street in the lower level. That's every third Thursday of every month at Thorn Township. Thank you, Mayor.
Anyone else?
May I be recognized, Mayor?
Go ahead.
Happy New Year to everyone. As the mayor said, you never know when you may wake up or someone in your family. Over the holiday, we lost a former trustee, Jefferson. So please keep his family in prayer. He was elected village trustee for 16 years. He was our finance committee chair. So just please keep his wife and family in prayer, because over the holiday, we did lose it. I hope that 2024 brings us happiness, communication, and a wealth of working together. Thank you.
All right. Anyone else? All right. All right. Next on the agenda is Mayor's Report. So last year was really epic. As always, we had a lot of different things going on in our community. So I'm going to highlight all the positivity that's been going on throughout Dalton that maybe you might see in passing, because sometimes people who have tunnel vision, they go to the store, home, and then to work, and they never go and see what's going on in their own backyard. So first, I'd like to start with my upcoming events. January 17th, we have conversation with the mayor. So if there's anything that you have questions about, concerns, anything you need me to address, that's the day that you should come, and you will see me here talking about anything that's going on in our community. Township Talk follows that from January 24th. If there's anything you want to know about the Resource Center at Thorn Township, which Trustee Stan Brown just read to you, a lot of people don't know that I do so much more than what you see in headlines. For instance, we do pay your bill. So if you're struggling, you need help with your light, your gas, your water. He even just stated burial assistance, because people are dying left to right. And what I mean by that is, you here today, gone today. It ain't here today, gone tomorrow. So majority of the time when you guys come to me, it's too late. You guys wish you would have made it right with your loved one, said you're sorry, or just made. All I'm saying to you is just start now. It shouldn't be that it turned to a new year for you to make something right. Just make it right, because you found it in your heart to do something better than what you used to do. January 25th, we have senior tech classes, and that's also to help our seniors learn how to use their electronic devices. And with that being said, a lot of people, little do you know, do not know how to use their phones, do not know how to use their iPads or their computers. If you give it to one of the kids right now in the audience, I guarantee you they will run circles around you, because they know how to use those things. They own it 24/7. So I just want to stress out other services that we do have, which is transportation. We have senior services. So if you are a senior, you live in Thornton Township, not just Dalton, you can also come and get services or be around other people that actually live in your township. And a lot of people made friends that way. So all I'm trying to do is just spread a little love, a little joy, and let you know that you're not alone, because you're not. Right now, what I love about Trustee Stan Brown is they do a ton of outreach. We go door to door, we talk to the residents, we check on them, and guess who leading it? The youth. The youth is the ones coming to your house. They're making sure that you're okay. Some of you live alone, some of you, your family live out of state, and they make sure that you get the services that you need, such as a food box. Some people are struggling with food costs has went up, and right now we're making sure that you have everything that you need. So call us. Don't sit on the numbers. We give the phone numbers all the time, and that number is 708-596-6040. Again, that number is 708-596-6040, and you can reach out to Thornton Township to get help with any of those type of resources. Next, I would like to talk to you about our recap video. I did a recap video just to talk about what's going on in our village from last year. So, James, are you ready? Okay, so this is the 2023 recap for our village. You're going to see a lot of highlights from demolitions, streets repavement, alley repavement, sidewalk repavement, you name it, we did it. So stay tuned, because 2024 are going to be bigger and better. This, just before you press play, it starts off with our little Charlie Brown Christmas tree. And the reason why we have that is because the Board of Trustees want to allow us to get a bigger tree. Right now, we do have a bigger tree for this season, but I always try to start off from where we start and then what we are. So press play, please. So this is a recap. This is our ice rink here in the village of Dalton. As you can see, the kids are on it skating. We got the largest in the state, bigger than the Rockefellers. New police officers, LED stoplights. We made Wentworth a one-way.
There have been an eyesore due to all the accidents. And, been,
and if anybody lives here like we do, on 144, it been two houses that's been eyesore for years. So we tore them down to stop all the mess that's going on. We went to the schools, we put up speed bumps at all our locations in our village. This is our Easter celebration. That was really, really epic. Kids came out, they enjoyed, they had a ton of fun. As you can see, always packed. All the events are always packed. I became the director at large of the Black National Caucus. That's another position I hold. We repaved the alley, as you can see, right where the old Dairy Queen is, for those that know.
Mayor Tiffany,
this is
doing
a resident.
Great job over here. This is very, very much needed over in this alley.
And they're getting their alley pay, which they've been begging for years to get done. We had a stepper event outside at the rink. That was really dope. If you haven't seen Greenwood Falls, you should go by there and check it out. It's really, really nice. And it's something that's needed for community. We did sidewalk replacement throughout Dalton.
Sidewalks, Mayor, I appreciate this. We needed it. It was a long time coming. I'm glad you're in office now.
So this is my mental health school. I do this in every school throughout Thornton Township. We go into the schools and we talk to the kids and we educate them about mental health. And a lot of kids got a lot of help due to the fact of just coming. You got seniors on there with their kids, because the first rink is for the little kids, ages 3 to 5. And as you can see, the fire department did a one-on-one. We saw Trustee Stan Brown out there, Trustee Holmes out there. This is me walking the kids from school, which is Lincoln right there. I walk them over to the rink. I do a lot of festivities with the youth. So this is them on the rink. They did a day of fun at the rink. So these are the things you may not see, but you might hear about, but these are the things we do. We make videos just to show you. That's upcoming projects we got going on. These are the new firemen being sworn in. Our new deputy chief, our new inspector. This is me and the best ever director, superintendent, Stacey Correa. We had an issue and our tank exploded, our water tank. But thank God our water wasn't coming from that tank. We go back to parade, Dog Parade. We went along Greenwood Falls. Everybody was included. As you can see, the kids had a great time. We ended up, that's us, at Thorn Ridge High School off of Cottage Grove. Really, really happy. We do well-being checks, as you can see, every single year, every single month. We go, this is the hottest day, it was like 100 degrees. Everybody went door-to-door giving water to residents.
Last time we had
this is when we had FEMA come out for the flood, but it was for the July flood. This is our main pipe replacement. We ain't had that in over a century and years.
Y'all have loaned for forever. I know y'all had them trying just sitting there, or once they go past, they bag up. You're like, oh, they're gonna be done. And then y'all turn all the way around.
So we just want to show you the things we doing.
Moving despite what others may say, it's just time. It takes time to fix and repair the village of Dalton.
Yep. This is our roof and window replacement program. We gave free roofs and windows to all our seniors and veterans. It's a grant program. And that was something else that, you know, the trustees stopped. This is the tree trimming throughout Dalton. That was epic. It was on the west side of town where Trustee Norwood stays. But voted to stop it, but it went really, really well. This is us walking against cancer. Of course, out in other states, they give me good press. And this is us doing the flood for the September flood, pushing people out of the water, out of the flood. This is ice cream socials throughout the schools. This is all the things that I do as your super mayor. This is us meeting with FEMA. Throughout all your disaster, all your issues, we always talk. And as you can see, public works, police, fire, code enforcement, all hands on deck every single time. Watch my feet. And this is the rink. So then we turned it to a skating rink for the summer for the kids. This is me at conversation with the mayor talking about the grants, the money. That was the Halloween event. That was really epic. Ton of people. We utilized the Melon Fitness Center, which was the overpack. These are guns we removed off the streets. And this company here destroyed all guns that we collect. So I just want to show you that. So congratulations to the police department. Thank you. Thanksgiving food giveaway was epic. Lies all the way back to this area.
Mayor Hinyard, happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you to Mayor Hinyard. You know, and thanks a lot for what you're doing because it actually helps a lot of
happy
people.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
You hear my residents, they telling y'all, leave me alone, fall back. But one thing I love about them is that they always come to support. This was the tree lighting for last year that we had in December. Channel 7 came out, gave us good press. I appreciate them for that. As you can see, we got a mega tree now. We had a little Charlie Brown tree. That's what we had then. That's what we have now. And of course, we always give toys. We get tons and tons of toys away. All you have to do is register for any events that we do have. And what people loved about the toy giveaway is was they chose their gifts. It was like they was in a that's cute. It's like they was in a toy store, like Toys R Us. And the best part about it is kids can pick what they wanted. Instead of you just wrapping something up and they open it and they never play with it. These are good toys too. Not the toys where you turn it down and it break. Nah, none of that. You know, you have $20, $40 holler toys. This is us going into the event. Of course, my baby Justice. She was my elf. She was Santa's helper. A long, long way to go. And where we'll end up. And this was the toy giveaway, what it looked like in the gym. So as we gave toys out, we kept opening more boxes. It was really, really nice, guys. Yep, really nice. So we made this video just to show you guys what we truly do here in our village. These are things that don't get the light of day. These are things that people try to overshadow with negativity. But our goal, our job is to show positivity. And as you can see, all the kids are happy because I'm real big on the youth. I'm real big on they are next, despite what others may say or think. You got to get a hold of the babies. Somebody got to care. Somebody got to love on them. And look at them, they had big bags of toys. They didn't even have to go shopping no more after they left me. And then whenever they come, they eat too. Look at all them toys. So it was really nice.
Hello, everyone. I just want to say that this is such a blessing and a great experience. Tiffany has blessed us and her community. She has been amazing. And God bless her. And I just think that she's doing a wonderful job in our community. I think that she's a wonderful person. And everybody should pray that she stays for a long time. God bless everyone.
I know you refuse to be held down anymore. But seeing is always believing, of course. Nothing, nothing. Stand
It's the food giveaway. We also gave turkeys, ham, ham hocks, green seasoning salt, Lori's at that, name brand seasoning salt, sage. You had a whole meal.
It was a nice experience. I appreciate all the toys that they received my kids. I'm very blessed. Thank you.
No, she got so many toys. She got the tray today.
I want to thank Tiffany for all the gifts that she did for the community and how she helps out everybody. I've been out in Dalton for 22 years, and this is the only change I've seen in 22 years. We need to support her, even the trustees.
My favorite mayor. Only one I ever seen do anything.
And everybody was trying. Because one thing they can't say is that I'm a visible mayor. I'm always on the ground. I'm always on the floor. So that's my gift to you guys. I just want y'all to see with your own two eyes what it is we truly do here in our village. So I thank all those that support me. I thank you for all your prayers, all your letters, your text messages. Thank you so much, because without you guys, sometimes people don't know how they hold on. So encouraging words are good for this year. It's good for the soul, because at the end of the day, can't nobody fix it but you. You have to fix what you feel is broken. If you feel something's not going right in your community, you can always reach out and we will try our best to get to whatever that is and then do better. If it's something that you're upset about, just know that it did not get done like this overnight, and it's not going to get fixed overnight. It's going to take time to fix what you guys feel is broken. What I'm trying to show you is that you've been neglected for so many years that I need you to know what love feels like and look like, and that's what I oppose. I send love and show it, and I take care of the people no matter what. I don't care what poison people put out there. Y'all live here. They don't. Internet and people, especially my board meetings, can say whatever, but at the end of the day, we grew here. They flew here. And for that saying, I need you to see that my work speaks for itself. And then I show you video so you can see with your own two eyes, instead of somebody coming to tell you what we're doing. You can see, and then you judge a person. Don't judge people off of hearsay or what somebody say or think they're doing, and don't got no facts to what they're putting out. But it's sad, because when you do things like that, guys, you get people attacked. You get people doing crazy stuff, and y'all forget, I am the first. I'm the first female youngest mayor of Dalton. And then I'm also the first female African-American supervisor of the largest township. And I get attacked because I cannot and will not be controlled by people that thought I was young or naive and thought that they can walk over me. That is not going to happen, ever going to happen. And y'all know that. So people got to go and do a spin cycle, a smear campaign, because they can't beat me. I'm letting you know, they can't. So they have to go and try to defame my name by putting out mess and poison. And that's the sad thing about it. When I'm the only one that's loving on you. Y'all been watching the news. Y'all been seeing what's been going on with T.D. Jakes and all of that. What'd he say? They trying to kill me while I'm trying to help y'all. It's the same situation. They trying to damage my character when I've done nothing but for years but love on the people and show y'all that. So when y'all hear things or think of things, come and get the facts. Come and get receipts before you judge, because people can make videos, and that's the problem. They hating, but they taking notes, though, right? I make videos, y'all make videos, right? So y'all really taking a lesson from me. I know I ain't going to get my due for it, but I'll take it as flattery, so I appreciate it. Thank you. Next. So all I'm saying to you is, like, come on, guys. We got to do better. We have to do better. And all I can tell you is that I am a fighter, and y'all know that. So when you come for me, know, be prepared for the fight, because at the end of the day, they talked about Jesus Christ. So why don't I think y'all are not going to do me the same way? Somebody that's healing y'all and helping y'all. Same thing I'm over here doing, right? Healing and helping. But yet y'all don't even see it, because you're so blind to what the negative is that you don't even see the positivity that's before you. And you've seen them are true testaments. There's no tests, right? Without a test, you got a testimony. You got to have a test. So all I'm saying is, you see true people that's talking to you on the camera about never seen nothing like this done ever in Dalton, ever. You never seen a mayor. You got kids saying they want to be a mayor. They know who Tiffany Inyard is. Man, the world know who I am for that matter. Thank y'all. Appreciate it. Because you opening other doors and putting my name on tables that you never would have thought it would have been. So I appreciate it. But at the same time, now it's time to clear up the mess, because people think that y'all going to get away with all the defamation of character and all the negativity stuff. You've seen me do none of that to any of them. None of it. Because I don't play like that. I'm busy. I'm too busy working. I'm too busy going to knock on doors and get money and bring back to my community. These are facts. These are things you can go check. These are things that I've done and accomplished. Y'all talk about people going out of town, but yet all the mayors before me went out of town. Rally went to Hawaii. Did y'all talk about that? Did y'all make noise about that? No? Hawaii. But that's my problem. And when a woman do it, everybody got a problem with it. But when a man does it, it's no problem. But it's the same laws. It's the same facts. It's the same salary that everybody had before me. And that show you that people are really, really geared up by people's salary. That's sad. Because I didn't know how much nobody made. I ran because I care and I just wanted to fix my town. Didn't care about the salary. Why? Because any of y'all that know me know that I am a business person. Business person. Had everything I got before politics. Well, politics. Everything. But thank God. God blessed me. Put me in a place to receive and to give back to my community. So when we go out of state or we go out of town, we bring back money to our community. And that's how we're able to create programs for you. And we make up a budget. Instead of fighting me and talking mess, come help. Don't hinder help. But people can say that out their mouth because it sounds good running off your tongue, but it don't mean it. It starts with us. It's a shame that it's black on black crime. I'm already got a lot of racial stuff that come my way, but it's a shame when I got to fight my own people. It's like, dang, every night I got to fight to prove my love. Why? When y'all know I care. I've shown you that. You've seen that. Y'all know this. These are facts. People that don't live here don't know what goes on in Dalton. They don't know where y'all come from and where we are today. That's why you hear everybody's testimony saying, hey, you're the only mayor that have done this. I've been begging for this for 30 years, 40 years. That's how long I've been here. I've never seen anything that I've come hitting the ground running, making sure I provide everything that you ask of me. You guys say you want more sidewalks done. You guys say you want street repavement, alleys fixed, tree trim. I go get it. But it's shameful that the board, when you get here, they got to shoot down. I go get grant money and bring it back. And all they have to do is vote for the money, meaning a resolution. We went in, what we got? $600,000 to build a water park right there on Greenwood Falls. Why our communities can't have the same thing that we all run to? We all take our money out of our community, everybody, because we don't have nothing here to choose from. But I said, enough of that. We're going to make something to choose from. We're going to have Restaurant Row, 10 sit-down restaurants. Who don't want that? You got a three-story restaurant getting built right there off of Lincoln and Sibley. Come on, all glass, elegant stuff. Who don't want that? You got your own ice rink, skating rink, your own basketball courts, your own areas where you can have a family reunion or a gathering for you and your family. Who don't want that? People, wake up. You got to want more than what people telling you are vomiting in your ear. You have to. But it starts with you. You have to make that change today. Don't wait. Make the change today. So with that being said, I just want to talk to y'all about all the things I had going on and all the things I've been doing for the community. So I just want to leave you with that because this is Mayor's Report. And I'm going to move forward so we can get through our agenda and our board package, because we got a lot of stuff to talk about this evening. But I wanted to give you some positivity before we start our board meeting, because it always start positive, but it always go left. Because at the end of the day, state facts. Don't lie up here. State facts. All right, next on the agenda, mayor's veto. The veto is, don't have it. So there's a veto for a secret squirrel meeting that the Board of Trustees had. And they had a secret squirrel meeting at the Park District. Anyone that knows how government works, you guys are a violation of Open Meetings Act. It's more than two, three, four of you guys is considered a quorum. You cannot and should not be having secret squirrel meetings. It's a shame that the Board of Trustees left the board meeting that was scheduled that Monday and went to have their own little fake mayor, he want to be called mayor so bad, meeting that Tuesday with the same exact agenda that we had on Monday. Make it make sense, y'all.
you could have handled the same business here that you wanted to go have at your fake meeting that you should have had here when the entire body was here. Myself, the actual mayor, and also the two trustees, Trustee Stan Brown, Trustee Andrew Holmes. The clerk even involves herself by getting in the mess when she's supposed to be a neutral factor in it all. For those that don't understand how the politics works, you always stay neutral because there's no side. Your job is to do your job, not follow nonsense. So with that being said, I am vetoing their meeting for, I don't even know the date. What was the date? Okay. So the things that I am vetoing is the approval of an estimated levy. And what else? Yeah. And I'm going to let the attorney explain a little more, but I just know that it was the estimated levy, and she said it's one other thing. So, of course, I just already stated Open Meetings Act violation. That's the other thing that you're in violation of. So I'm going to let the attorney speak to it so you can understand what's going on.
Yes, thank you very much, Mayor. On December 5th, the Board of Trustees held a special meeting at the Dalton Park District. And at that meeting, one of the agenda items was a motion to accept and approve the preliminary estimate of the 2023 property tax levy collected in accordance with the Truth in Taxation Law in Illinois. My understanding and the mayor's understanding is that when the Board of Trustees did this, they also may have approved the actual levy. However, state law requires that there be a 20-day gap between the approval of the estimate and the approval of the actual levy, and there was no 20-day gap. So they couldn't have actually approved the levy on December 5th. So the mayor is vetoing both the estimate of the approval of the estimate of levy and the purported alleged levy that was approved December 5th, as it did not comply with the Open Meetings Act, because the Open Meetings Act, or I'm sorry, the agenda item did not say approval of the levy. And in addition to that, it does not comply with the Illinois Property Tax Code, specifically Section 18-60, which again requires that not less than 20 days prior to the adoption of its aggregate levy, the corporate authorities of each taxing body shall determine the amounts of money that they're estimating for the levy. So in the mayor's opinion, as well as in our legal opinion, the action did not comply with state law. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much. So that's for the mayor's veto. So we're going to move forward. We do have executive session. We're going to get through everybody's reports and we'll try to go through. Did she leave? The attorney. For closed session. Okay, so we have to do a closed session item, but we're going to get through the reports and then we will go to closed session and come back up. So next we have Village Clerk's report. All right, no report. No, why not? Been off a long time. All right, next, Village Administrator report.
Good evening, Mayor, and Happy New Year to everyone. I just like to start by saying I think that everyone did a great job last year, and I want to thank all of our staff in the mayor's office for making sure that we are able to do our job and have the proper tools and resources that we need to do it. I think you do an honorable job, and I think everyone up here appreciates everything that you do. So thank you for your time. Thank you for your consideration, and thank you for supporting us. my report is brief today. I just want to make sure that, number one, everyone knows that snow is coming. So I'll leave Public Works to give you guys the details, but make sure that you pay attention to the snow routes. And also, if something happens or if you see something, say something. Roads can be slick. There are a ton of things that can happen when you have inclement weather. I just want everybody to be prepared so that they know, hey, listen, the winter's coming. It comes every year. Just make sure that we're prepared. And then we'll have some discussion later on from the engineer about upcoming streets and alley projects and some other things. So I want everybody to have a happy new year, be safe, and make sure you pay attention as the inclement weather comes in. Thank you, Mayor. I appreciate you.
Next, we have engineer's report.
Thank you this evening, Mayor, Madam Clerk, trustees, department heads, and residents, Village of Dalton. Happy New Year to everyone. In 2024, we will be having new infrastructure projects. These projects will be funded through the motor fuel tax funding and also the Rebuild Illinois funding. We'll be doing street resurfacing, alley improvements, and sidewalk replacement. The village did receive a $1.8 million grant through CMAP. That is to redo 154th Street from Dorchester to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Drive. The other project will be completing the 16-inch water main replacement project that's right behind Old Village Hall. Also, the village will be in receipt of a $200,000 grant from DCEO for fire hydrant and valve replacement. So I'll be working with the fire chief and public works. They will be identifying those hydrants and valves that are to be replaced this year. That concludes my report this evening, and I will entertain any questions that the mayor board may have.
All right. I just want to say thank you so much for your support. And thank you for always making sure we go bring money back to our community. So appreciate you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Next, we have department heads, police, Chief Lacey.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. And I want to say Happy New Year to everybody. Hopefully it will be a safe one because that's our direction. Moving forward, the Dalton Police Department responded to 2,247 calls for service. We also wrote 634 parking citations within the village. State citations, we were 170. Red light violations were 4,418. Major crimes are down in the village of Dalton. I would like to thank the public for heeding to not leaving their vehicle running, because that was, in fact, a big factor. People want their vehicle to be warm when they get in it, but they leave the keys in it. So, which means, guess what? A crime of opportunity. They take the car. So thank you for listening, Village of Dalton, to that message. Also, Mayor, I'd like to say which direction the police department is going in. We were currently on 12-hour shifts, which actually what that was doing was we've been on for like 2.5 years, maybe more, and it would actually burn the officer out, not to mention the fact it was costly. Starting this new year, which was Monday, we went back to 8.5-hour shifts, which gives the officer a break into resting and just recouping their body, because let's be realistic, it's hard out there as far as when they're jumping in and out of that car and the calls that they're responding to. So we went back to an 8.5-hour shift. We're also, with our traffic unit this year, we are going to be utilizing a grant, which is from IDOT. And what that grant is when the officer gets out there for 4 hours, a four-hour grant, we are reimbursed. The village is reimbursed, so which means we recoup that money that whichever's spent when the officers are out there enforcing traffic. The other thing I'd like to say is, and Mayor, you touched on it as far as Wentworth. Thank you, because guess what? We have had little to no accidents at that location since it's been made a one-way. So thank you. So moving forward, I just want to give kudos to Stu, Devontae Stewart, and Chief McCain, because we have become a dynamic team in getting things done. So I'd like to thank you guys for being there whenever I need you, and we're going to look forward to moving forward in this coming year. That ends my report, Mayor.
Thank you. Thank you. Next, we have Fire Chief McKay.
Thank you, Mayor. Good evening to you. Chief Lacey, thank you for the nice words. It is a pleasure working with everyone in public safety, as well as all the department heads here and the administration, and I appreciate everybody. And Happy New Year's. And to the clerk's office, trustees, all the department heads, and to all the residents of Dalton, Happy New Year. 2023, the fire department had a total of 5,616 emergency responses. 1,890 of those were fire-related motor vehicle accidents, and 3,726 were emergency medical incidents. Again, for the grand total of 2023, 5,616 runs. Training objectives. The members of the Dalton Fire Department have conducted thousands of hours of training, totaling not only on-duty training, which they do daily, and outside classes. And those classes consisted of fire behavior, fire science classes, fire officer development, building construction, safety, water training, technical rescue training. We have 6 members that are part of a CART team, which is not only in our Mavis division, but they could be deployed throughout the state. So I'm very proud of that. Well, we have 6 members a part of that team. hazardous materials, emergency medical training, as well as all the other incidents that anyone in this community, if they call 911, we're here to respond to, take care of you. You're our residents. And of course, to the firefighters going out in the community and performing pub ed. They're going to all the pub ed events at schools. They're reaching out to the community. And it's very important that they're touching the youth to keep the village safe from fire. So I'm very proud of those guys. And again, I thank you for the opportunity to serve the village. And that will complete my report.
Thank you so much. Next, we have Public Works, Stacey Carrai.
Thank you, Mayor Henry. Good evening, residents and board members. Productivity report for December 2023. Public Works repaired 6 B boxes, 8 water main breaks were repaired, 3 emergency water shutoffs, 5 sewers jetted, 2 street lights repaired, 3 trees trimmed, 5 restorations, and 16 blocks were pothole patched. As winter weather approaches, please be on the lookout for water pooling from the ground and or icy surfaces, which is a good indication of a water leak. If that is the case, please contact the Public Works Department at 708-201-3280. That is between the hours of 7 and 3:30 regular hours. And for after hours, you can contact dispatch if it's late at night. You can contact us at 708-201-3240. I would like to send a special heartwarmed thank you to the men and women of the Public Works Department who are constantly being called out to fight our water main repairs. I know sometimes they get a little hectic and people get tired of the pressure going up and down and things like that. But the men and women, they come out middle of the night, no matter the temperature or the weather, to make these repairs, which is also a very dangerous job. So I would like to send a special thank you to the men and women of the department who helps keep us with services. Mayor, that concludes my report.
All right, thank you. Next, we have water, Ms. Juanita.
Good evening, Mayor, board, staff, and residents. I would like to start off by wishing everybody a happy and prosperous new year. Water department has been continuing sending out water shutoff notice. Payment plans are still available with the first installment of 50% down. Please contact Thornton Township for assistance with your water bill. CETA is no longer helping with water bills. If you have any questions or concern about your water bill, please contact me, Juanita Darden, at 708-201-3273 or 708-201-2977. Also, the Water Department Payment Center is open on Mondays from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Thank you, and that concludes my report, Mayor.
Thank you. Next, we have Code Enforcement, Kim.
I want to start with the housing report. For the month of December, we had 22 rental licensing totaling $4,400. We had 31 as-is cell inspections totaling $6,850. We had 42 escrow release checks deposited equaling $30,500. We had 64 housing tickets equaling $28,732.97 and 13 vacant property registration totaling $3,500. The total amount of revenue generated for the month of December is $87,632.97. And for building and permits, we had 66 building permits totaling $31,339.29. We had 12 contractors licensed totaling $3,850. We had 39 plumbing permits totaling $1,808 with a combined total for the departments of $126,138.41. And Code Enforcement Department issued 178 tickets totaling $32,375. And that ends my report, Mayor.
Right. Thank you so much. Next, we're going to go to closed session so we can get the paid attorney out. Is there a motion to go to closed session?
Motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, just for the record, the reason for the closed session is discussion of litigation.
There's been motion and second. Please follow up.
Mayor, I'd like to move the executive session to the end of the meeting for the sake of the residents' time. It's getting darker early. I feel as if we should move the executive session to the end.
All If we can get her off our payroll, because y'all did that last time, she had to sit through the entire meeting, but she's still on the clock.
Well, as Trustee Belcher mentioned last time, maybe it'll be more cost efficient if we ask that the attorneys come a little bit later, since we know that we probably won't start to 7:00, and then we're going to do this for an hour before we get to executive session. So that's already 8:00. So,
well, it's a motion and a second on the floor to go to closed session. If you guys don't want to go, then that's the answer. So can you please call the roll?
Trustee Norwood?
No.
Trustee Stan Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
No.
Trustee House?
No.
Trustee Holmes?
Yes.
Trustee Belcher?
Yes.
Oh, wow. All right. Get the break the tie. All right. Let's go downstairs, closed session. Yes. I'll get the break tie. All right, so we will be back. We're going to go conclude a matter, and then we'll be right back up. It shouldn't take no more than 5 to 10 minutes. I wish we could do it up here in front of you, but we got to go in closed session, and we'll be right back upstairs. Thank you so much. All right, testing, testing. All right, we're back. It's like 10 minutes. All right, is there a motion to resume the regular scheduled board meeting?
Motion.
There's second. It's been motion and second. Please call the roll.
Aye.
Trustee Norwood?
Aye.
Trustee Stan Brown?
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
Aye.
Trustee House?
Aye.
Trustee Holmes?
Aye.
Trustee Belcher?
Aye.
All right. Meeting and resume at, let me see what time it is. Sorry about that.
All right. We're going to have the attorney read it to record the motion, and someone just motioned and seconded. All right. Go ahead.
Okay. The motion that we are asking for from the board is a motion to give settlement authority to the attorneys as discussed in closed session.
Is there a motion?
Motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
It's been motion and second. Please call the roll.
Who second? Belcher.
Thank you, Belcher. Trustee Norwood?
Aye.
Trustee Stan Brown?
Aye.
Trustee Tammy Brown?
Aye.
Trustee House?
Aye.
Trustee Holmes?
Aye.
Trustee Belcher?
Aye.
Motion passed.
All right. Next, we have corporate bills. Trustee Stan Brown.
Okay. electronic warden list for November the 30th, 2023. Corporate payment register, $363,676.15. Water fund register, $685,903.14. American Rescue Plan register, $32,713.20. For total corporate payments of $1,082,292.49.
Is that your motion? That's to pay the bills? All right. Is there a second?
Second.
Man, motion and second. Any discussion? Call the roll.
Mayor, I have a comment on this one.
All right. Go ahead.
Okay. I do have some amendments I want to suggest. There are items on here that and this is the credit card warrant list. As a board member, I have not seen the credit card statement since May. I have not had access to receipts on any of these. So there are some items on here that I would like to amend if this motion is unsuccessful. Thank you.
Did you make the motion that you wanted, what you want to change?
Well, there was a current motion. I'm waiting to see if that's it. Should I amend it now?
You want to amend the motion? You want to change
Are you trying to make a superseding motion?
If I can do that, I would like to, yes.
Well, procedurally, so that's what you're trying to do. So you're trying to do a motion over the current motion that's pending?
Sure, yes, let's do that.
Okay.
Go ahead, make your motion.
Okay, I would like to make a superseding motion. I'm going to write that down. I'd like to make a superseding motion for the bills as read, amending and removing the following items on page 2, Aurelio's Pizza. $131.63. Page 2, Best Western Plus, $318.14. Page 2, Chicago Midway Airport, $200. Page 3, Cooper's Hawk Winery, $557.68. Page 3, Dollar Tree, $145.32. Page 3, Food for Less, $107.99. Page 6, Irie Jerk Hut, $1,356.22. Page 6, Italian Fiesta, $113.59. Page 6, JJ Fish and Chicken, $68. Page 7, Johnny T's Bistro and Blues, $90.30. Page 7, Kirk's Barbecue, $676. Page 8, Potbelly Sandwich Shop, $126.57. Page 8, Ruby Soul Food, $674. Page 9, Sophia Tamales and Corn, $2,400 even. And page 9, The Tasty Crab, $458.79. My motion would be that we pay the bills as read, removing the items stated.
All right. Is there a second? Second. Okay. It's been motion and second. Any discussion? All right. So I have a discussion. So, yeah. Well, the problem I have with you guys coming to board meetings and acting as though y'all don't get things, I don't appreciate. I think this year you should tell the truth that you guys don't do your job. And if you need information, you should ask for information that you feel you need. Don't get to a board meeting and put on a show. How you gonna lead, Trustee House, when you don't even know where to start? You have to lead, stop leading blind. You're leading them blindly, and y'all following him. That's the sad part about it. Prime example, this is a what? Electric warrantless. That means they did what? It's already spent. So how dare you get here and showboat for the people out there in the audience? You already know what it is. So why are we sitting here playing this game, wasting time, saying I'm gonna take this out, that out? It's already been paid. Come on now, stop playing. This is 2024. Let's move forward. Let's handle the business. Stop letting the business handle y'all, because y'all keep coming playing games. I'm just over it. Like, come on. Let's focus on the business. Move forward. And if anybody know what our authorities are up here, which let me remind you, if my authority is $5,000, y'all pulling out $200, $100. Stop it. If his authority is $20,000, stop it. That's what I'm saying. It's a show. Stop sending the people off. Let's move forward with the business. It's an electric warrantless. That means it has been paid. But go ahead for the optics if y'all want to do that. Call a roll clerk.
Mayor, you asked for discussion, then I tried to speak and you start talking. So can I?
I didn't start talking. Y'all didn't hear you say anything. But if you want to say something, just ask to be recognized again.
What can I?
We're
going
to run this business the way it's supposed to. Let's be respectable. Follow Robert Rules of Order. But go ahead, since you got something to say now.
I do have something to say. It's an electronic warrantless, electronic. Also, you made it very clear that these have been paid last meeting, which I said, and the finance director wasn't here at that time, but I'm so glad she's here now. She stated that we didn't have a credit card anymore because she said the trustees cut it off.
That's so true.
Okay, so if we don't have, I requested in the email, could we get the final statement? Because if we haven't received the credit card since May of 2023, and she stated that we cut it off, no documentation has showed that it's been cut off. So what card are they using outside of ACH debits?
Okay, before you start, yeah, I'm gonna give you the flow. Let's clear some things up. You guys did cut it off. When? You guys, hold on, I'm going to explain it so you'll know. You guys had control of the bank account that Trustee House did illegally, and Clark Key went illegally and hijacked the bank account for an entire year. You know, like I know, anybody that understand money know that you cannot see anybody's information when someone else is on the bank account.
That's it, not means a debit credit card.
Hold
it's
on.
A credit card. Not
that's
a debit
what I'm
card.
Speaking of. You going to let me finish?
Go ahead.
That's why I said we got to be respectful. You go say ahead. Your stuff, I'll be quiet. You got to be quiet when I talk. So what I'm saying to you is that if you guys have done that, which y'all did as trustees, no one up here could see anything that y'all was doing for an entire year. We didn't have access to anything because Jason House was on a bank account and so was Allison Key.
the mayor wasn't on it. So we couldn't call, check up, check in, see what was going on, because you guys was the holders on the account. So that's number one. Number two, I'm going to let her respond to your question, because you get here at a board meeting and you know how to pick up the phone, call my phone. Right. Hopefully you'll do that this year, since you said you want change and you want us to work together. Mm-hmm. It had to start by starting Trustee Belcher. You can't sit here and say that out your mouth and then don't do it. Look. So we're going to see what happened, because you could have called if you had questions instead of coming, put on the same show we just did for an entire year. Y'all should be tired of that. Y'all should be ready to actually do some progress in the village besides sit here and we arguing over warrantless. Come on now. People do work in our village. They should be paid for the work they have done. But yet y'all hold a progress, hold the people hostage, picking and choosing who y'all want to pay. That's not right. That's discriminatory. You guys are discriminating against people because what? They didn't give y'all money for y'all D2s? Like, why do y'all pull people out of this trustee house? Y'all need to stop with the mess. Go ahead, finance director.
Good evening. Our bank accounts do not have a debit card, to be clear. The credit cards are issued by the bank. The last card was canceled or suspended in June by whoever had administrative rights over that account, which is not anyone sitting up here.
Thank you.
That staff. So the last statement that you received was in June for that account.
Okay. The last statement we received was in May. I said it, and I was very clear when I said it. I said in communication, because you just stated be respectful to people. Not you, Tanjanique. I'm talking to the mayor. Be respectful. But Janice Johnson had access to the account. So for mayor, for you to sit there and say only the clerk and Jason House, that's an absolute lie, because she cuts the check. So I'm sure she wasn't cutting the check blindly. Also, we have stuff on this list from June. She makes the decisions what checks go out, what y'all tell her to hold and not hold. So that means she had access, because we had emails from the bank that showed the people that had access and control. Because at some point, you guys stopped letting the clerk and Jason House even see what was in the account, and they had to send the information via email. So don't get up here and say nobody had access to the account, because Janice Johnson, and I'm sure the finance director, Tanjanique, had access. Nevertheless, I just want to be very clear, because I requested, if you're saying that it was canceled, show us the June statement that was canceled, because for at some point or some shape, form or fashion, when you did get back on the bank account and the clerk was on the account at the time, the last statement starts showing the American Express card that's been used through the police department. When Tanjanique said there was no credit card at all, when the American Express car originally had $3,000 here, $3,000 there, that we were seeing until we were moved from my viewpoint. Now it's $37,000, $50,000, $28,000. So that means that all of the transactions that was on the Fifth Third account have now been used through the American Express card. I don't care if it's Fifth Third, American Express, U.S. Bank, we're entitled to it. So please just give us access to either accounts payable again on my viewpoint, or the credit card, so we don't have to sit here. We can see what you spent it on and move forward. I see something on here that Trustee House took off, which I would have been like, oh, I think I know what that is from the way that it's line item. But I'm not going to sit here and fight a battle that I don't have a receipt for. So just be fair.
Can I address
go ahead.
Janice had access to see the account, to print out bank balances, which we had to do based on a court order.
Yes.
That's why we provided bank balances mm-hmm. daily. That was by court order.
Right. But the mayor just said that nobody had access to it.
Administrative access was only by the two people who were over the account, which mm-hmm. they were the only ones who could add or cancel any card mm-hmm. on the account. That was not something Janice could do. She cool. did not have that access.
Correct.
Any check that Janice cut had to be signed by those two people who had administrative access. Janice could not issue a check without those signatures first.
Preach.
Trustee House or Clerk Key, did either one of y'all cut off the credit card?
No.
Okay, thank you.
From the bank.
Please forward the email to the Board of Trustees.
You can have it tonight.
Next I've been waiting on a whole lot of stuff.
Okay,
that you said
so
email
tonight. I have a comment, Mayor.
Okay, go ahead.
When we're talking about access to the bank and the information, myself and Clerk Key, checks were printed by the finance department. Checks were presented to myself and the clerk. We would sign the checks, assuming they were approved on the warrant list. Once the checks were signed, they were handed immediately back to the finance department. Now, what happened with the checks beyond that point was beyond Clerk Key and myself's knowledge. Some checks were released. From my understanding, some checks were not released. But that's past the point of our role in that process. Secondly, when we're talking about the credit card, I made no request to cancel a credit card. I would have liked to. I'll be honest with you, I would like to, but I made no changes. That the everything was scrutinized through the court. If there was something improperly done, the court would say so. So there was no changes. And then additionally, when we're talking about credit card charges, in order to make a charge on the credit card, you have to have the credit card in your hand. So every item that we're talking about being charged had nothing to do with myself, had nothing to do with Clerk Key. It had to do with the card holder and the person that had the card in their hand. I didn't take any trips. I didn't fly anywhere. I didn't do anything that benefited Jason House or anybody else improper. Every charge we're talking about was done by the card holder. And so whoever authorized that, that's their responsibility. As Trustee Belcher mentioned, all we're really asking for is the documentation and the proof. Personally, I would say ask that it be put on the website so that way it's transparent, because we spend a lot of time in this meeting saying, I sent that, I didn't send it. At this point, please, anything you send to me, put it on the website. I'll get it for myself. Thank you.
Go ahead, Tajanique. So you keep saying allege. That's not a true statement. Allegedly, use it the right way. Because when they give you the check, it's the items you voted on, Trustee House. And for the record, it's many a time this body, this board, have voted for you guys to sign checks and you refuse to sign the checks at all. So when you state facts, state the truth, state facts that make sense. You're making up things that sound good for you or what you feel that you want doing or whatever with a credit card. Stop. It's all like a spin cycle up here. That's all y'all do. Y'all get up here. We put on a show for the outside world. But yet, if you guys want any information, I'm going to say this and I'm going to say it again. All y'all have to do is ask. All y'all got to do is call me. I tell all y'all that. Don't none of y'all call me because y'all too busy fighting. Y'all too busy doing a smear campaign. And all y'all do is call if y'all wanted any type of information, any. But no one calls my phone. We get to a board meeting and we sit here for hours going back and forth over, you said this, we doing this, this was going on, this person got the card. Like, come on, stop. It's kiddie stuff. It's like I'm over it. Like, stop. Let's move forward. And all I was stating is y'all making a show about something that's already approved and you pulling it out that's already approved. It don't make sense. It's for what? Optics? To chop up a video? What is for? Because it ain't the truth. I just wish y'all just focus on the truth. That's all I want. So we're going to move forward because we'll be here all night. We're on the electric warrant. We still
May
got...
I be recognized?
Okay, 1 second. We still got AP warrant list and 3 other items. So go ahead.
Mayor, we in the spirit of working together, because it is 2024 and we all just sat up here and stated that our whole goal is to work together for the betterment of the community. When you sit here and you see... You hear me? When you sit here and you say we don't want to go back and forth, we do not want to go back and forth. But then you all say out of your mouths, we have credit card statements that we don't have. They're missing. They're clearly missing. If we do not have them, if they were not emailed to us, if they were not sent to us, and as we all know, my viewpoint access, our access has been denied, restricted, should I say. So yes, we can access it, but we cannot look up receipts. I remember as a trustee, you sat in that very seat and you stated to the mayor at the time that you would not blindly vote on bills or options that you've met on things that were purchased that you cannot present receipts or evidence for. You stated that out of your mouth as a trustee. So it baffles me that we sit up here and now that you're the mayor, when the very trustees are asking for this information, you're stating in that term, oh, well, we've sent it to you, knowing that you all didn't. We're not asking for anything that you didn't ask for as a trustee. Let's first make that clear. We're also missing financial statements. We haven't received financial statements in months. How is it that as a board, we're over the finances? That's the trustee's job. We keep hearing, oh, well, no one's doing their job. No one's doing their job. This is our job. We are here for checks and balances, whether you all like it or not. So if we request the information, it should be provided to us. But yet we sit here and then we have invoices. We have emails every day. Dear Village of Dalton, let's start here. Dear Village of Dalton, I have a payment for work that I've done. I'm going to take out the invoice number for their privacy. Where Village of Dalton purchased, they purchased lights. The board approved the lights in June. Here it is. We're in January of the following year. They haven't received payment. Here's another email. Please see email below from the vindicator indicating that he has not received payment or communication on this bill. Payment invoice. Then he have all of these invoices. This object was approved by the board in September, and we're steady waiting for payments.
Hold on. There's one more.
Are you done?
No, there's one more. Hold on. Let me locate it. Here we are. 9/11 from this vendor. We called Keith at 12. He said that the check was mailed. We spoke to Janice. They said that the check was mailed. The email was sent. Several calls to the villages, which were all unanswered. Then we sent emails to the following trustees: Jason House, Brittany Norwood, Kiana Belcher. So when we're receiving these invoices and when we're questioning these things, we're not doing it to go back and forth. There has to be some type of transparency. We will not be able to work for it as a village if we don't have transparency. And that's all we're asking for. If you don't want to email us the receipts or provide us with the receipts, make it easy. Provide us back with access with my viewpoint so that we're not back and forth. But I just want to state for the record that it's unfair that as the mayor, you don't see fit for us to receive this information. But as trustee, this is the very thing that you were fighting for, transparency. Thank you, Mayor.
For the record, trustee, you guys get everything that we have. We send an email, you get the financial reports, you get everything, and I've shown that in videos. Now you want me to go do some more work and show you again that you get what we tell you you should have. Now, as relates to transparency, we have been nothing but transparent here at the Village of Dalton. You guys can do spin cycles, scare tactics, tell people that we not when we are. At the end of the day, I keep stating this, if it's something that you don't feel comfortable with when you come to this meeting, you have literally 48 hours to make sure you reach out, ask questions, bring up an invoice, talk about a receipt, whatever it is. But y'all all choose not to, because this is your only time to get on a platform and talk or say whatever you want to say. When y'all really, if you're going to be adult about it, call somebody's phone, ask the question. But y'all don't. So now when y'all get up here, you point the finger, this person ain't doing this, this person ain't doing that. Well, all y'all have to do is pick up a phone, call, get your questions answered, and you will have everything that you need. But yet we got to sit here and throw tantrums and go back and forth with one another about what you said, you did, you didn't get, all of that. Like, come on. Like I said, y'all should be tired of it. Y'all can't keep coming up here making the same excuses when y'all not doing y'all job. That's really what it boils down to. Until y'all do y'all job, y'all can stop with the mess. Miss me with all that in 2024, because we here to do the business. So with that being said, call the roll, Clerk Key. Let's move on. We got another warrant list, please.
Clerk Key, is this vote for with the amendments?
Yes, it is. Oh, yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
Trustee Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Stan Brown.
No.
Trustee Tammy Brown.
Aye.
Trustee House.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
No.
Trustee Belcher.
Aye. Motion okay. Passed. Moving on. Like, that was pointless. That was just dumb. So now moving on. AP warrant list. Trustee Stan Brown.
AP warrant list. January 2nd, 2024. Corporate payment registered. $2,537,872.56. Gross payroll, December 1st, 2023, $442,198.62. Gross payroll, December 15th, 2023, $468,898.71. Gross payroll, December 29th, 2023, $520,000. Additional payroll check, $362.06. Melanie Fitness Center registered, $14,502.20. Total corporate payments, $3,983,834.15.
All right, is that your motion?
It's a motion to accept these bills as read.
All right, is there a second?
Second.
The motion and second. Any discussion?
Yes, Mayor. I also have a superseding motion.
All right.
For this list as well.
Okay.
I would like to request the bills as read with the following items removed. Page 9, existing concrete, $14,123.03. Page 10, five star, $62,375. Page 12, John's Pro Tree Services, $155,000. Page 13, K&M Ventures, $183,950. Page 14, Lopez Lawn Maintenance, $10,050. Page 17, Pekarsky and Sons, $30,740. Page 18, Raul and Sons, $181,950. And page 21, 2J's Sheet Metal Works, $58,750. My motion is to approve the bills with the amendment stated.
All right. Is there a second?
Second.
The motion second. Any discussion? No.
I have one comment or question. For the bills that are approved on this list, will those checks be released this week?
Every time you guys approve bills, we do release the checks.
And I'm asking that specifically, as Trustee Norwood mentioned, and there I've sent, as you asked, I've sent several emails about vendors who have asked for payment for things that were approved. Be more specific, Third Millennium and Associates sent the email on December 1st. They indicated $17,000, which was approved in August. Pure Tech, $32,500, email sent on December 19th. They were approved in August. LED lighting, that's the stop signs, the flashing stop signs, look really good. $17,999.80, that was emailed to on 12/19 asking for status. That was approved in April. Mako, $20,000. That was emailed on December 11th. That's for payment of multiple invoices. And D's Construction, $378,620.64. Again, I emailed without a response on December 15th. That was approved in July. That's the reason for my question is if just to confirm, I have your word on record. So that's my statement. Thank you.
Okay. So why do you guys keep taking things out of the warrant list that the people need? Why would y'all take out the concrete company? Why y'all keep taking stuff out that matters to the residents? Help me understand that, Trustee House. Why did you take that out?
So the items that I take out.
I'm talking about that one item right there. Concrete. Why did you take that out? How do Public Works keep going? If y'all take out people that supply us with things for water main breaks, because we had a whole issue when y'all did this same dance and show when it was Thanksgiving. And we didn't have any cold patch. We didn't have nothing because you guys took it out of the warrant list. So how do you provide for the residents when y'all play this game?
Would you like me to respond?
You should respond.
Okay. My statement's been the same for the last 4 months. We have bills that are piling up that are way past due. We cannot afford them. And yet we continue to go out and get new bills and accumulate new things without following a budget, without a plan, just willy-nilly, hey, go over here. You get a plane ticket. You get some restaurant food. So at the end of the day, we have to pay all of our back stuff. Public Works again. Has Public Works been paid yet for their back pay for 4 years? Now we're past due. That's a lawsuit that they can file at any given moment. We also have other unions that are 4 years past due. We have tons of bills way past due in addition to the bills that I just read into record that need to be taken care of. So if those bills get taken care of first, pay your old bills first, then we'll look at the new bills. That's my stance. Thank you.
Okay. So that's excuses because at the end of the day, we still got to provide the service for the resident. Regardless of your thought or how you feel about things and how it's ran, our job is still make do with what we have. So right now, if we have to order concrete or need a, like I just said, a water main fix, a hole patch, It's people that call us every day about things like that. But you guys sit here and play this silly game and not take care of the people. Your job is to provide for the residents. Yet, you guys won't even pass a tax levy. You guys won't even pass a budget. All these things warranted, the things that you're asking to be paid, such as union negotiation, contracts. And you just stated for the record, you've been here, what, 6 years now? So 4 years ago, you just stated, right? 4 years ago, you was the same trustee sitting there, right? So these are the same problems y'all had 4 years ago. All we're doing is trying to clean up what has been broken for so long. And if you guys would just work with me and stop fighting on every little thing, we will be a whole lot further as a community. There's no unity here. All you guys is create chaos. Y'all chaos agents. That's all y'all do is go and create mess. But with no solution. Name one thing y'all have came up with and done in this community. Nothing. All y'all do is say, point finger. Oh, she doing this. Oh, he doing that. But y'all ain't did nothing for other people. So prime example, I'm arguing with y'all over concrete. Concrete that's way within our purchasing power. If our purchasing power is $20,000, we put it on there to be transparent for the record. Because y'all keep wanting to use that word. But all I'm asking you guys is do what's right. Stop picking and choosing people to not pay. If they did the work, pay them. What is the issue? Pay them. Y'all voted last time to pay. Well, not y'all. That's when Tammy Brown flipped on y'all. Voted to pay everybody, including her friends. But yet you and the clerk chose not to even sign the checks. Y'all don't even sign the checks after the board voted to. Y'all just say this how the game go, right? We put it up. They vote for it. And whatever check come up, we supposed to sign them. Y'all didn't sign them at all. So let's talk about how you still got things sitting. Things sit because y'all refuse to sign the checks. So if you refuse to sign the checks, what does that mean? That's my problem. Y'all have to do better, Trustee House. You can't want to lead people and can't lead, man. You got to do better. I keep telling you, just because you wear a suit don't make you suitable. Stop. Stop. You got to do better than what you're doing right now. And right now, you're doing is keeping up confusion, keeping up mess. You got to grow, man. All right, moving on.
Can I please make a statement?
Yep, make your statement.
4 years ago, we were not in this mess. 4 years ago.
Yes, we were.
So, correction, we were not in this mess. We were paying bills. We did not have vendors emailing us on a weekly basis for non-payment. Yes, I did approve to pay my friend, and it is January 2024, and my friend still ain't paid. Along with other friends didn't sign the check, so let's get that right. Let's just make it, you know, be for real, be 100. People are not being paid, you know. So this is nothing that nobody's doing a grandstand show. The emails are here. If anybody would like to see them, I can print you a copy, and I will block out the other information. So yes, again, we were not in this mess 4 years ago. We were able to pay our vendors because we follow the budget. That's the reason why you make a budget, and it is to be followed, not to spend and do as you want to do nilly willy. Thank you.
Okay, not true, trustee. Let me take you down memory lane. Ooh. Don't y'all have somebody from Five Star Meeting? Remember, came for this body, and y'all owe him money from 2019, 2017, so y'all wasn't paying y'all bills. Stop lying to the public. Y'all wasn't. Like I said, y'all got a grandstand on everything. And we got the invoice to prove it. Y'all saw it. And
wasn't you on the board?
Hold on. Pause. Your friend wasn't paid because your friends, Trustee House and Clerk Key, did not sign the check. And then I brought it up at the next meeting and I said, hey, they didn't sign the check. So what you going to do? And you sat there, right? Didn't do nothing because it was okay. They can't make up government. The problem is they trying to make up government as they go. But all y'all do is keep losing. Y'all making a fictitious play world of y'all run stuff and y'all don't stop. I am the executive branch. Y'all are the legislative branch. That's it. Know your place. Learn your seat. And that's the problem y'all got. Y'all overstep. Y'all have to know what to do and y'all don't. That's why y'all keep losing. Y'all getting school from our attorney, the village attorney. Y'all got legislative accountant that y'all pay. Y'all talk about budgets, right? But y'all been paying that man, right? Y'all been putting him
absolutely
on one list,
not.
Right?
You haven't
y'all
paid
been doing
him, that.
Trustee,
so
you are out of order.
You stop telling
so y'all
those
been
lies.
Doing that, right? So
you
y'all should
stop lying.
That. Y'all keep on having this attorney come in, make up these fake lawsuits that y'all keep losing at the taxpayer's expense. That's what y'all keep doing. Y'all need to stop.
but yet he's on payroll. Did y'all budget for that? Is it a line item for that? No.
It is.
No, y'all didn't budget for it at all. And that is the problem. It's good for y'all, but ain't good for us, right? Y'all could do what y'all want, but the minute we say, hey, hold on, y'all. Let's change this. Let's fix this. Let's do something different. Y'all keep talking about all that happy medium stuff. I told you, that's all fluff. And then we get to this point, and then we got to fight over bills, pay the vendors. They did the work. It's like y'all want us to have bad credit. Y'all want us to have a bad image to the public that we don't pay our bills. That's the image y'all got out there. Why? Because y'all get here and people scared to come and do work in our village. We are a village, guys. This ain't no mom and pop store. We supposed to be known for paying our bills, our vendors, not sitting here and pointing out who we gonna take out. We don't do that, but y'all do. Call a row.
Hey, clerk, for verification, this is
we done with discussion. Clerk. Call a row.
Clerk, is this with amendments? I'm talking to the clerk.
Clerk Key.
Is this vote for trustee? Thank you. Thanks, clerk. I appreciate it. Aye.
Trustee Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Stan Brown.
No.
Trustee Tammy Brown.
Aye.
Trustee House.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
No.
Trustee Belcher.
Aye.
Motion passed.
All right, here we go. Also, too, y'all know I'm the receipts lady, right? I always got paper trail for all of them. They were saying that they credit card that we line. Here's the proof right here, an email stating that they canceled the doggone credit card from the bank.
Don't worry about it.
I'm going to give it to all y'all, including the public. But my point to y'all is stop believing the lies. They lie so much up here. It don't make no sense. Like I said, every night I got to prove my love. Every night I got to show y'all what it is. It's sad. They lie because they can't beat me. I keep telling you, they trying to run a campaign on lies. Ain't going to get you nowhere. Nowhere. Next on the agenda is new business. Is there a motion to terminate contract with Odison, Sturk, Murphy, Frazier, and McGrath, LTD as legislative counsel? Is there a motion?
Motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
It's been motion and second. Any discussion?
Yes. Can I be recognized?
Go ahead.
Okay. For one, I don't understand how it's new business and you keep putting it on the agenda every period. So I'm going to ask the attorney and refer to the attorney. At what point, if it keeps voting down, is there something that says it cannot go
on? Nope, I'm going to put it up on the agenda every board.
Okay. I asked the attorney.
I asked the attorney. And I just asked.
Okay. So then my next thing is, because she sit here and tell these lies to say that we are paying an attorney. She has not paid the attorney. She wants total control. So she thinks that she's the only person that can have an attorney. And then we have no legal representation. That's for the board. If you look at the budget for anybody that was here during the time when they had a fictitious town hall meeting, which if that's what they call it, it says $455,000 was spent in actuals for legal counsel. $432,000 of that went to Delgado. So when people sit here and they sit there and talk about what they got receipts for, what they don't have receipts for, she has not paid Bert Odison. So as long as Bert Odison, McGrath, or anybody else want to give us free legal advice at this point, pending payment, we're going to accept it. So you can put it on there every meeting until one of us is absent, two, three, four of us is absent. But you're not going to sit here and keep trying to control the situation where your attorney, because he made it perfectly clear, he worked for you. He don't work for us. We didn't hire him as corporate counsel. We hired Delgado Firm as the prosecuting counsel. So technically, we don't even have corporate counsel. But for you to sit here and keep lying, saying that we are paying somebody that you know has no check has been cut, you need to stop. It's ridiculous. And you sit here and talk about, I did this, I did that. They lying, they lie. She sat here and just pulled up a piece of paper. If you got something that said that it canceled it, and I'm sure all of y'all, including you, was on the email, we requested it, why wouldn't you give it to us? But you say we sit here and wait till we get here to ask the question. If she had something, she should have sent it to us. Then we wouldn't even have the discussion. But for you to sit here and keep sitting lying, talking about somebody, first, we can go back, pull the meetings up because she's good for pulling them up. First, she said we paid them $600,000. Then we paid them almost $1 million. But if you look at the actuals, only $455,000 been spent in legal costs, and most of it went to Delgado. So who lying?
All right, you finished? All right, go ahead, Tangenie.
Odison was not budgeted for in the budget.
Thank you.
Legal counsel did not have no description of who it is.
Let her
finish. So Odison was.
You see how she was quiet and heard you? You got to be quiet.
You a liar too. Trustee House and asked him on what page was Odison budgeted for. I still have
legal expense.
Trustee, let her finish. You see how we be quiet and let you do your little rant? Be quiet. Let her talk. She got the floor.
I am not justice. You're not telling me.
It's her time. You have to be quiet.
No, I am not.
Go ahead. Go ahead, Tanjanique.
I just wanted to make it clear that was not budgeted for.
Legal expenses.
Yep. Oh, my God. That's your problem.
That's your problem.
Be quiet.
It was not amended and added. It was not budgeted for. And it is not included this year either.
Legal expenses does not show
trustee. You cannot overtalk her. Let her get her point out like you just did your rant. So you have to be quiet to hear her side like we was quiet to hear your side. Stop. Point of order. Follow Robert rules of order, please. Go ahead. Go ahead, Tanjanique.
Was not cut. That does not mean the expenses were not incurred and you're putting the village of Dalton on the line to pay those expenses.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Miller.
So as we go on and we talk about this and we go back and forth, as you can see, people are so out of order, so disrespectful. You got to give respect in order to get it. If we talk and we be quiet, you got to give us the same courtesy. Ain't nobody interrupt you, whether you was lying or not. We shut up and we listen to your lie. Now you be quiet and let the finance director respond to you like how we just did with you. As it relates to y'all attorney don't do nothing. So if you saying free help, give that back. Because if it's free, it shouldn't be for you because he ain't winning no cases for you. So why would you even have a person like that around if they causing the village, the taxpayer money? Also, y'all walked out of that last board meeting, right? Y'all to pay no bills. Reminding you that we still got public works, police, fire, all these expenses, the day-to-day operation, the light bills, the gas bill, all the things to run a business was still at stake. But y'all walked out. Tire your month went by, right? That's what I'm talking about. Y'all don't care because who walks out on the people? I don't care whatever y'all want to bring up about fighting back in the day or whatever, but I never walked out on the people, but y'all did several times. Y'all walked out on a $33 million lawsuit. That's why we got the $33 million lawsuit right now. Y'all walked out again at the last board meeting. Y'all walk out on everything. Y'all got to sit here and sit in the fire. If you don't like it, so be it. But that's what discussion is for. We go back and forth, hopefully find a happy medium. If we do not, then guess what? Then them people are just don't get paid because y'all chose not to pay them for whatever reason that you thought you shouldn't pay them. And it's warranted. That's what I'm tired of. Y'all should pay people after they have done the work. When there are storms in our community, we had a storm, right? What was y'all faces? I ain't seen not one of y'all on the block. I ain't seen not one of y'all helping nobody. Not one. Trees was on cars, trees was on houses. And guess what? The day before, y'all chose not to pay them vendors. But every single vendor came out and took care of the people. Every one of them. That's because of what? You network, relationships. They didn't want to leave the people high and dry. So they said, you know what, Mayor, we got you. We're going to come out and we're going to make sure the people are taken care of. That's what I do as a leader. You guys just talk and talk about nothing and ain't producing nothing. And that's my problem. Y'all talk, but ain't putting in no action and no work. At least my work speaks for itself. No matter what y'all want to put up against me, go lie to people, bring media here. Who tears down that town? Like, think about that for a minute. Y'all black. Black. Look how we fighting. African-American community fighting like this. Over what? A title? A seat? I told you all our bench warmers. Everybody got to go. At the end of the day, you wait your time. You wait your time. Your turn ain't here yet. We don't run to 2025. And then you let it be what it be. Like I said, then you come and run against me. But all that little fake stuff y'all be trying to do, it ain't working. And it ain't going to work. As he said, any weapon formed against me ain't going to prosper. So y'all should stop. Call the roll, Clerk Key.
Mayor, I have a comment.
Now you got something else. Go ahead.
So the entire meeting is set up for an argument. Information is not given to the board. And then we get in here and set up to say, yes, I did. I keep asking the same thing. Let's put it on the website. We don't have to go back and forth. We don't have to do any of this show. The same item has been put on the agenda for the last 9 meetings. I'm exaggerating. But the mayor did say she's going to keep on putting it up there, knowing that there's not enough support for it. It's set up just for us to come in here and argue.
That's the whole intention. Come in here and argue and then state, I don't want to go back and forth. I mean, we know most people say definition of insanity, doing the same thing, expecting a different result. It's insane to put up the same item knowing it doesn't have support. But it's set up for the argument, it's set up, and then to twist it and say, oh, board, you're doing this and you're doing that. It really doesn't make sense, but if we have to, if it has to be voted, put up there 9 times, or put up there 15 times for us to go and do it. But just understand, we talk about why the whole back and forth, the meeting is set up that way. As board members, we can look at the packet. And I'm sure the mayor, everybody looks at the packets by now and say, oh, that one right there, that's going to be the argument. Corporate bills, we know that's where it go up. So, like, well, I don't think even most people tune in until about an hour into the meeting, so that way they can get to corporate bills. But again, the meeting is set up for an argument. Sorry that it's set up that way, and hopefully we'll do different in the next meeting. Thank you.
Trustee, yep. That's definitely not true. And then you should basically pause on the things you actually say. If it's set up for an argument, then why take the bait? Stop it, because it ain't set up for an argument. The whole point is to show people that y'all are full of crap. Y'all put things up on here. Y'all spend taxpayer money. Y'all do all this wasteful spending, but point the finger at the lone wolf, the one that's still standing, right? The one that's still standing. Y'all point the finger at me when it's you guys that's really running amok. You four. Trustee House, Trustee Belcher, Trustee Noah, and Trustee Tammy Brown, who don't read nothing. She listens to what y'all tell her to do and come and vote accordingly. So state facts. And I have all the proof always of everything y'all lie about. But yet we got to put on a show like we always do to sit here, go back and forth for hours about nothing when y'all can just do right. All right, Colorado.
Leah, I know we still in discussion. We still in discussion. I know she had a speech, but I was waiting.
What is that? I can't hear you. I hear none. You just said
you, we were in discussion still. So I said, I know you were talking. So I was waiting on you, but.
You got something to say, Trustee?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, go ahead.
And this is just for the record, and I'll keep it fast. It's the hypocrisy for me. Again, as trustee, she sat in this very seat, and when she felt the mayor was withholding information that she was entitled to, she did the exact same thing, which is get their own special counsel. So when we have this discussion, and it's like this is some foreign that just these set of trustees decided to do, just for the record, it is not. This is what people have to do when they have a leadership that is not transparent. Thank you.
Trustee, you ain't getting the flow no more. You repeat the same thing every time.
Okay.
You need to stop repeating the same thing. Just for the record. I'm just letting you know. We done with that. Move on. Call a roll, clerk. Call a roll.
Mayor, could I?
You got something?
Yes, ma'am.
Go ahead.
I'd just like to say, you know, to us as the trustees, in December, we had 3 paydays. And you had individuals on the police force, the fire department, and public works. They were wondering if they was going to get paid, have money for the holiday. We actually had a payday December the 1st, December the 15th, December the 29th. And for us to not to even approve that, that was totally unfair and disrespectful to these individuals that was worried about, were they going to even get a check for the holiday? Mm-hmm. So that's just something to think about, you know, when you just walk out like that. That's unfair to them. That's unfair to them and their family.
All right. Colorado.
They got paid, but we had a meeting on the 4th, and we got the holiday coming up. We got the holiday coming up. We got the holiday coming up.
Everyone was paid, Stan.
Hey, Jason, I don't need glasses on when I talk. Yeah, I don't need glasses on when I talk. So let well enough alone. Stay with that lane where you at, because I'm just putting the point out here for people to understand what's going on up here. So it's going back and forth, and I'm not going to participate in the little back and forth going, but I'm just looking at individuals that have spoke to me about this. So I just wanted to relate it to you guys. So when you just up and walk out of meeting, think about other people that's going to be involved in that. You're not just going straight at the mayor, because what it is now, anybody around the mayor, just take it out on them. You don't care about the residents, such as you guys say. And you talk strong about the retro pay for public works. When you stop worrying about public works?
You know, so now we getting all that, and we know what's happening right now. But I just wanted to put that on your head that you walked out with three paychecks for that December. Yeah, they got paid. Yeah, they got paid. Mm-hmm. But it was just a threat you put on them when you walked out the meeting on them. Thank you, ma'am.
All right. Clerk Key, call the roll, please.
Thank you. This roll is for termination of contract for Otison Murphy Frazier McGrath as Legislative Counsel. Trustee Norwood. Trustee Stan Brown.
Yes.
Trustee Tammy Brown.
No.
Trustee House.
No.
Trustee Holmes.
Yes.
Trustee Belcher.
No.
Motion failed.
And for the record, residents, he tried to take $2 million from my insurance policy. So it's a shame that they keep up with the mess. But stay tuned. Stay tuned. Next, is there a motion for approval of the 2023-2024 annual appropriation ordinance / budget? Is there a motion?
I have a motion with amendments.
Okay. Go ahead. Okay.
My motion is to approve the ordinance. I'm going to read into record. There are several amendments, and then I will email.
Can you, did you give that to our team, whatever the amendments are?
Which was my statement. I will read
the sentence. Can you give them that? Can you print that so they can follow with whatever you're speaking of?
I do not have a printer right here, man.
So see how you ain't come prepared, but you want us just to listen, and you already got your mind made up of what y'all going to do. But these are the department heads that should understand what it is you're going to take out of their departments.
Okay, so my motion.
Can you send that to us now so we can print it so we can follow you? Can you email that to Keith Freeman so we can print it out so they can follow you, so they can understand what it is you're about to do for their department with the amendments?
Sure. Oh, let me connect.
And print that so that everybody up here can have it. You got this? Do you have this one too? You want one? Yeah, she made several. Okay. Is it sent?
No, I'm still connecting to the Wi-Fi.
It's funny, man. We have to sit here and send stuff, but when we ask stuff, we have to wait and never get it. Yeah, why she doing that? Can you make sure you get a copy of this canceled bank card and credit card? Keith, can you make sure we get a copy of that? The information too that Tanjanique just got to the mayor saying that the power was canceled and we're just reporting out stuff. I would like a copy of that right now, like everybody else is giving their stuff right now. I'm just saying, since we're waiting on him to send something, if y'all print stuff, can you get that to me? Like I asked you for something earlier, too.
Did you stop him?
I'm asking him a question.
You know what I'm saying? Chill out with all that. Okay, you got the email? Okay. Print that out so everybody can go be done with all this.
Okay, so motion is to approve the budget as presented.
with the following adjustments: line 01-00344 reduced $6.8 million. Line 01-00344.2 increased $200,000. Line 01-00-391 decreased $525,000.
Why don't you tell the public what that stuff is? You just saying line items and not telling them what it is.
Line 01-12-420 reduced $110,000. Line 01-12.
What is that, trustee?
Mayor, you're going to get a printed copy.
But no. Hold on. Pause.
I will tell you this.
Don't tell me I'm going to get a printed copy. Tell the public what you are decreasing and increasing. You're talking about transparency. Be transparent. Because right now you're just saying numbers.
And you can
tell the public. No. You should tell the public what you're doing right now. You want to be transparent. Go ahead. Tell them. So we all know what that line item is. They don't know what 01.22 is. Tell the public what that line item is so they all understand it.
Line 01-12-421 reduced $50,000. Line 01-12-422
that's a shame. You can't even tell the public why line what you're reducing, why you're doing it.
01-123
trustee
reduced $62,000. Line 01-12-424 reduced $25,000. Line 01-12
and this how stuff get hidden. Y'all don't even know what them numbers are.
Line 01-12-581 reduced $270,000. Line 01-12-592 reduced $115,000. Line 01-12-460 reduced $300,000.
No,
line 01-12-710 reduced $155,000. Line 01-15-421 increased $25,000. Line 01-15549 reduced $500. Line 01-15-563 increased $2,000. Line 01-15-830 increased $3,000. Line 01-12-421 decreased $1.1 million. Line 01-21-422 reduced $300,000. Line 01-21-426 reduced $900,000. Line 01-21-428 reduced $5,000. Line 01-21-598 reduced $15,000. Line 01-22-427 reduced $130,000. Line 01-22-426 reduced $27,500. Line 01-22-428 reduced $400,000. Line 01-22-453 reduced $25,000. Line 01-22-611 reduced $40,000. Line 01-25-421 reduced $25,000. Line 01-41-421 reduced $300,000. Line 01-41-520 decreased $250,000. Line 01-41-557 reduced $250,000. Line 01-41-598 decreased $60,000. Line 01-41-629 decreased $50,000. Line 01-41-830 decreased $25,000. Line 01-42-421 decreased $50,000.
Are you done?
Line 01-42-611 decreased $80,000. Line 01-46-597 decreased $70,000. Line 01-44-423 decreased $50,000. Line 01-47-451 decreased $25,000. 01-47-596 decreased $5,000. 01-47-597 decreased $7,000. 01-12-996 decreased $100,000. 01-21.
Stan, you want one of these?
Decreased.
Drew, you want one? Because I know they ain't give it to y'all.
01-12-512 decreased $35,000. 01-41557 yeah, decreased $25,000. 01-41572 decreased $25,000. That is my motion.
Wow. Woo. Woo. I don't even know what to say. Byron, I don't even know. Look, it's a shame that people just sit here and read all these numbers to y'all. And y'all don't even know what they are. But they talk about transparency. Oh, my God. I can't make this stuff up. I don't know half the stuff he just read, but I'm about to read it in record for you so you can understand what they just did to y'all. This is the budget for your town. This is your day-to-day operation. Just so you understand what they just did, right? They didn't talk to not one department head, find out what the need was up here for public safety, housing, code enforcement, nothing. Y'all even took out the $6.8 million grants I went and got for y'all. That's sad. That is sad, guys. But okay, here we go. Let me see. He ain't got it like where it's itemized like it should be. He got salaries in administration. You want to reduce it by $110,000. You took away the grants of $6,800,000. You took away the CDBG, or you try to increase it. Okay. You took away the Homewood disposal. So residents, for those that don't understand how this game go, Homewood disposal, that's your trash. That's to pick up your garbage. How are you to get your garbage collected if they took it out of the budget? How do we pay, guys? They're not telling you the fact. This is the hidden stuff, but we talking about transparency. Transparency, right? So then we goes to salaries for human resource. We got 50K. Yeah, well, you should tell them. Yeah. And see, the lawyer, the attorney that educating them just said that this is that we created in the past, of course, for $500,000, and we have to pay it. How you gonna just take it out of the bun? Like, what the heck? Where you get the money from? I'm just saying. But this is stuff they do, the nonsense they do, right? So after that, let's keep going since they took time to do this. A grant writer, they took out 55K for a grant writer. Salaries for customer service, they took out 62,000. For the youth program, oh my God, y'all don't want to help the youth. They took out $25,000. Oh, that's right, y'all don't do nothing no way. Okay, then you got printing. You took out $10,000 for printing. How you get stuff printed? You got to print the water bills and all these other things, but okay. General liability, you took out $270,000. Special events, oh, you don't want us to do activities for the community, $115,000. You also took out, what is this? What settlement for what? I don't know what that is. So settlement of $115,000. You took out maintenance supplies for building. This is how we keep up our buildings, all our government buildings, water department, public works, what is that? Fire, police, all of them, right? The maintenance, they took out $155,000. So when a furnace go out, when a boiler go out, how y'all gonna fix this stuff? I'm just saying. All right, let's keep going. Let's keep the party going, right? Because he didn't want to tell you what all these numbers was, want to read numbers, right? Transparency, though, right? Nope. I'm gonna be transparent with you. Then we got salaries. Where we at? Nope. We got salaries, $1 million. Okay. Who y'all cutting by $1 million? Okay. Yep. And then you got, what is this? Maintenance supplies for $300,000. Then you got salary overtime for $900,000. And y'all know that's the police department, right? So when you got crime, a shooting, a domestic, anything, who y'all gonna call? Ghostbusters? I'm just saying. Who you gonna call? So then you got maintenance of vehicles, $5,000. So if the truck get broke, I don't know how we're gonna fix it. Then you got other miscellaneous expense. Don't know what that is. You put $15,000. Then you got ESDA. Y'all don't want emergency services. Okay. So if it's a car accident, you want it to be manned by a police officer, not an ESDA worker. Make it make sense. This is the stuff I'm talking about. So they took that out of $130,000. Then you did clerks. So you're going to decrease the clerks by $27,000. I hope that's clerk key. Then you got maintenance of building, $40,000. You got more salaries, $25,000. These are all reductions. They cutting up the budget by all this money. Then you got regular salaries of $300,000. Then you got maintenance of sidewalks. That's the number one thing everybody keep calling about. Sidewalks, streets, and alleys. You're going to deduct it by $250,000. Stop it. I'm going to double it next month. Next, you got other pro services, $250,000. Then you got maintenance supplies and other $50,000. I don't know what any of this go to, but this is how he wrote it up. But I'm going to read it into record for you. This is all for the record, by the way, Clerky. And please do not say refer to a mayor's office because this is all from Trustee House. Then you got maintenance service, $80,000. Then you got other contractual service, $26,000. Everything I'm reading is they trying to deduct it. So I'm not going to say negative or minus so you understand. Salaries, you got $5,000. salaries regular, they got $70,000. You got salaries for code enforcement. Wow. You want to deduct by $50,000. So if you got an abandoned house, don't call us because I don't know who's going to write the ticket because you're just going to get squatters and issues. I don't know who's going to enforce, right? Then you got medical insurance premium of $25,000. Board up, you want to take from board ups to $5,000. Other contractual services, $7,000. Operating transfers, $100,000. Lease payments, $220,000. Another maintenance line, $35,000. Hauling, so that's like the debris and things when they cut down trees or when they do the milling, that's $25,000. Operating expenses, another $25,000. What am I missing? Any more? That's it. Okay, then you got $400,000 for fire. So that's for overtime salary. So I don't know how y'all gonna run an operation with all these cuts. Please make it make sense, guys. But again, you see how he just did, y'all. We'll tell y'all the items that he cut. You see the amount of money that he cut. How do you run a village without any of those services? These all of them that sit up here. They didn't ask them one question about their department. They didn't ask what they needed. They didn't ask where they can cut or trim at. Nothing. This is how they run government blind. They running it blind. Three blind mice, four blind mice. They running it blind. It's a shame that they got no visions for our town. It's a shame that they going to cut all these things for you residents. What you supposed to do when y'all call us? Well, how do we handle this? When we say, oh, we sure, we can't get nobody to your house at this time, but I got an issue. I got a robbery in progress. Oh, we can't get you an officer. That's stupid. Y'all need to fix that. You should amend this, trustee house. I don't think you should dare do this. I think you should amend this. I think that the residents deserve better. I don't think that it should be left up to you guys just to pick numbers and make cuts for whatever your reasons are. I just think that you guys didn't do a good job of talking to the staff about the things you want to cut. And then the lawyer just stated to me, because these are the people that do all of the litigations, that we have current litigations pending. So we do in negotiations. So how do we go to the table when y'all are cutting everything? But this is how they put our village in the financial condition that we're about to go in due to your board of trustees. So thank them when you see them in passing. Thank them for all the mess, because at the end of the day, all it takes is a conversation. So you will know what to do, how to do it, what people got going on in their departments. First is communication. Got to talk to people. Can't just make up stuff because you think this what it is. You don't run day to day. You wouldn't know what it is. Or talk to the VA. He run day to day. But no one does that. And now we're going to vote on a budget that y'all know isn't right. That y'all know this ain't what we need. Y'all know that, right? Trustees, I'm throwing this out here. Hoping y'all change y'all mind. Y'all know we need better, right? Y'all know we're cutting down more trees. We're basically cleaning up the west side. And now we're starting on the south side. We're putting up more street lights. And by cutting the trees back, we can see the actual light on the block. Y'all do know we're doing streets. Y'all know we're doing alleys. Y'all know we're doing sidewalks when, once upon a time, they used to pay 50-50. Now the resident don't pay nothing. And that's through the CBGD grant that y'all took out of the budget. Why would y'all do that? That's money. What's wrong? I'm so lost at how you decided to come up with this list. How did y'all decide to come up with the list? Trustee, how you decide to come up with this list?
Okay. So in looking at the budget, we looked at years historical. And historical years, the items you're saying are cut out are not cut out. They're reductions to be realistic. The budget that we were given had numbers that could not be substantiated, or I don't believe that could be substantiated. We talk about in the last meeting, we asked about the $6.8 million, the alleged $6.8 million that's coming. It's an appropriation. Asked when will it come? Could not get an answer. Asked that repeatedly. And if there is a $6.8 million, when you complete a budget, you also have to fill out the expenses, which means it's going to be a net zero on terms of the budget anyway. So all these, and we talked about, oh, overtime police before this administration that did not have security details following them around everywhere. Overtime was at $600,000 maximum every year. This administration is at $1.6 million. How are we going to get service? We need the mayor to stop spending money irresponsibly. That's where the reductions came, is off of all of the all the expenses that were not necessary until this one came in. And she even said in here, oh man, forget that, I'm gonna double it.
Yep.
That's the reason that we have vendors calling, because we can sit here and put it down there, but the minute that you go out there, tell a vendor you're gonna do it, and then there's not enough money in the bank, which is what we're running into today, because we're receiving lies about money that's coming in. It went from what, 6.8 million then to 15 million. Never see it in the bank. Don't ever see it in the bank. And the minute it starts hitting the bank, we can add it in the budget. But other than that, we're just kind of there. I'm just going to conclude on that point. I think my point is made. Thank you.
Yeah. So y'all need to stop with the mayor just spending, the mayor this, the mayor that. If we budget for items, we spend for those items that's budgeted for. I can prove everything that you all accuse me of up here. That's y'all problem. It's hearsay, but you don't see me ever talking about y'all, because y'all nowhere. I'm everywhere. Now, as relates to a budget, you have to put the $6.8 million in the budget. If the money comes through, how you gonna get the money? You ain't even got it in the budget. And y'all know it's true. Every outlet, meaning media, wrote about it, because everybody was mad. Like I said, when I leave, go anywhere, I bring back a bag. I got awarded $15 million. Then you have to wait until it come down the pipeline like anything else. Anybody understand grant money? And when you go and ask for the grant money, you have to be specific in what you want to use it for. So here it is, my boy, once again, just like I did a $600,000, right? That we went, got, secured, came back to this body, and you guys didn't even vote for it. It's grant money. It ain't coming out the general fund. That's the problem with y'all. Y'all want to lead and don't know how to lead. Won't you follow my lead and you will understand how to do things, like how y'all follow my lead by making videos. Like I said, that's flattering. But all I'm saying to you is that y'all have to do better. You can't come up with this stuff and just say things that's untrue. Then y'all talk about spending. You have to spend in order to improve your town. These are things that everybody been complaining about for years, and never got it. And then if you really want to sit and have an adult conversation, some stuff that I can really educate you guys on, you will understand where we get the money from. Because y'all keep saying that we this and we that. Where we get, what accounts it come from. We have all kinds of accounts that the funds come out of, but you guys don't want to just sit and educate yourself of how we getting trees cut, how we getting the sidewalks done, how we getting the alleys paid. No one wants to learn, and that's the problem up here. You guys are too prideful to come and just really learn from your super mayor. It's sad. But go ahead, attorney. She want to say some things. Hopefully y'all listen to her.
I just want to say a couple things as it relates to budgeting and appropriating, just as general principles. Essentially, if you don't appropriate for something and that money comes in, you then cannot spend that money. So if the $6.8 million in grants does come in, like the mayor stated it will, regardless, you're not going to be able to spend that money if you don't appropriate for it. So that is a very serious concern. I can understand that you guys may or may not believe whether it's going to come in, but my recommendation would be to put that in there, at least have it in the appropriations ordinance. If it does come in, then you can use it. If it doesn't come in, then it doesn't affect the budget appropriations ordinance at all, truthfully. And then the other thing I wanted to point out is that, you know, as the mayor had previously stated, we are in the middle of negotiating various contracts, and it really does tie our hands at the negotiations table when we're not able to make the same offers to other bargaining units that we've settled with. And it really just makes it very difficult for us to negotiate a fair contract. So I just wanted to point those items out to the board.
May I make a statement?
Go ahead.
So that was wonderful what you just said. But in October,
appreciate it. Yes.
October, Keith read out three other grants that he stated that we got. Those are not in the budget. So if we already been approved for those or applying for them or appropriating for them, then why are those items not allocated in the budget, like the $6.8 million. Then there was a statement that was made at a last board meeting that said that even with the negotiations for public works, that they wasn't paying it until May 1st of 2024, which is the next fiscal year. So if you have this money allocated in the 2024-2025 budget, but you don't plan on paying them to 2025-2026 budget, then why is it allocated in there? So if you're going to say that the 6.8 of the appropriation, then that means that everything that he read in October should be in there too, since we're talking about transparency and all these grants. So that should be in there also. And those are not being reflected in there.
May I mean?
Are you done?
Yes.
All right. Go ahead, Keith.
Was that a question that you were asking whether or not it was reflected, or is that a statement that you were making?
That's a question.
Because I believe that it's reflected in the $6.8 million. It's not individually broke out, but you didn't ask us to individually break it out, nor did you ask a question about that. So I think the first thing is before you make an assumption on a budget, you should probably ask the question.
I'm not assuming anything.
I'm just going based off of what you just said. So the second thing is that I would like to know what accounting firm helped you guys put together this budget. How do you guys plan on making up for the $500,000 that we're going to lose for Homewood disposal? You're not passing the bond later on. And is there any, did you guys think of anything? I mean, did you guys have any help with this? Is there anyone that helped you with this? Or are you guys just going off you guys basic accounting skills?
Is that
what
a question?
You learned in college? That's a question. Are you going off what you learned in college? Is this something that you learned in day camp?
Oh,
yeah.
Dang.
I know that's tough.
That's real tough.
There's no way in the world you could cut this much money out of a budget.
Yes, it is. Stop spending.
Well, I'll tell you what. If we didn't spend a dime until next year, you still wouldn't be able to cover the resources that you could cut out of this budget.
Yes, we would.
How? How do you know? What financial expert told you that?
Mm-hmm.
Please tell me. Oh, his name was Kasperic? Because I can get him on the phone right now. This is ridiculous. Well, hey, he's the accountant, right? I'd really like to know. Can somebody tell me? Oh, it's quiet now. In the words of Tiffany Henry, it's quiet now. I can wait. I have nothing.
Get the accounting firm on the phone.
You want to amend it? Okay, go ahead.
To kind of address Attorney Nelson Jaworski's comment, I would like to make one amendment for the appropriation. And so, I will state.
So just to be clear, you're doing a superseding motion to your own motion?
Talk to me. I think okay, superseding motion, all items read, but I would. I have great concern because about the $6.8 million. It was appropriated, but I have great concerns about it coming. And I did ask several times about time frame through via email, but have not received it, which added to my concerns. Hearing that it needs an appropriation, just to make sure that we're covered, I would remove the reduction of that from the revenue column, the 6.8, and leave the $6.8 million in the budget. I would also add on the expense side $6.8 million worth of grant expenses because when you submit the grant, you have to submit the expenses. So that should also be reflected in the budget. So I would like to leave the $6.8 million in there, add a $6.8 million line item to account for the adjustment just made. So that was my superseding motion is everything as read with the two amendments, and I will send that via email. Thank you.
So since you're amending stuff, you want to talk to the police and fire department since we are here and you could ask them questions of why they need what they need in a department?
Here's my question. How much was spent on the security detail? Because that adjustment came strictly because of the security detail, which we think we've never
The firemen don't protect me, so no, yes. It did not. Fireman.
I want to ask questions. That's my question.
But it did not. Okay, trustee, why are you so concerned about my security detail that you guys got me happen to have because all y'all mess that y'all created? Let's be crystal clear about that. So stop with the drama. Like, I'm over it. Y'all have no idea the things y'all created with just lies. I'm a single black woman.
So you better miss me with that. Start with my security detail stuff. It's in the CBA. Read your stuff. I'm sick and tired of coming here out to prove myself to people like you that don't even know what to do with it. If you want to run against me, you run in 2025, but you don't put my safety in jeopardy. Let's be clear. I'm not going to keep playing with y'all. So talk about something else. Sick of this. You sitting here bank rubbing the town. That's what y'all doing, bank rubbing the town. Because y'all cut all this stuff with no focus, no direction, no vision, no answers, no questions. Y'all just came and did it because y'all felt like it. That ain't how y'all run government. That's why y'all don't need to be in y'all seats. Because y'all didn't get the right advice. He asked you, clear as day, who told y'all this?
We asked where you get it from?
Hold on,
no
trustee,
answer.
You out of line. And y'all had no answer. But yeah, y'all keep coming up here, putting on this show. But you putting the people in harm's way. Stop it. Whatever our fights are, is our fights. Whatever we gonna do, we gonna do. But stop neglecting the people. Stop. I didn't run to neglect people. I ran to help them, Trustee House. How you run on my ticket, follow my vision, then get here to board me and then want to take a person out. That's sickening. You played it. Shame on you. You wanted to see, you should have ran against me, but you didn't. But now you got to create chaos to think you're going to win something that you ain't going to win. Stop. But what I will not do, and I'm not up here, is put my safety in jeopardy. I'm not. So stop trying to pick something to sit here and catapult you to something that you will never be. Stop. I'm sick of it. And for those women that's right here with you, sitting back, watching the nutball stuff, y'all should be ashamed of yourself, because I am you. But y'all sit back and do this little show like we ain't people. I'm a human being before anything. Stop. Call her out.
Ask Mayor.
Go ahead. Is anybody second?
Second.
All right. Go ahead, trustee.
You know, one thing about, you know, pulling a deducting this maintenance, you know, you're putting this village in harm's way. We can't afford, if these vehicles go down and the funds are not there, we can't afford to wait on another municipality to get their police here once the residents call. Fire department, the same thing. We can't afford, if that truck goes down, to wait on somebody else. You're going to put this village in a life and death situation. And the criminals are going to have a field day if our vehicles are not being operated or maintenance. We can't afford to cut anything in there. And once they find out that we don't have vehicles and they're waiting on Harvey or someone else to get here, guess what? It's going to be a field day here. And if our maintenance is not up to par in this fire department, we're going to have some lives lost. It's going to be a critical incident, and they're going to have a field day. You need to think about safety first. I'm done.
All right, cholera.
Do your thing. This was his amendments, correct?
What happened?
Every time.
Let me ask what I want.
Clerk Key, cholera.
Aye.
No.
Aye.
Aye. No.
Aye. Okay, welcome to Board of Trustees just bankrupt the Village of Dalton. Next, is there a motion to accept and approve the 2023 property tax levy collected in 2024 in accordance with the Truth in Taxation Law of Illinois? Is there a motion?
Motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
It's been motion and second. Any discussion?
I have a question.
Go ahead.
The attorney read in your veto that it was 20 days and you said an estimate. Could you reiterate what you said? Because I was confused, but it was the veto. Because the same thing that you're putting here now is the same thing that she vetoed, but you're putting it before us again. So
if I could clarify,
yeah.
And just to make sure it's my computer's of course not coming up right now, but let me just do it from memory. Essentially, section 10-68 of the property tax code requires that there be a 20-day time frame between the passage of a estimate of a levy and then a passage of the actual levy. At the December 5th meeting that you guys had held, so let me back up even further. December 4th, the item on the agenda was to approve the estimate of the levy. Then on December 5th, the item on the agenda again on the special board meeting agenda was to also approve the estimate of the levy. Mm-hmm. So it was not voted on at the meeting on the 4th because, as I understand it, that meeting ended when the trustees left. And it was voted on and approved. The estimate of levy was approved on the meeting on the 5th. What I honestly am not clear on is whether the actual levy was approved at the meeting on the 5th or if you guys just approved the estimate, because the agenda item only says estimate. However, there's been multiple conversations, as I understand it, where certain trustees have told various administration officials that the levy was approved on December 5th or was approved on December 5th, 2023. So in the event that the levy actually was approved, the mayor was vetoing that approval. Right. And vetoing the estimate because the estimate
20 days
because the understanding was that that the estimate and the levy were approved at the same time. Now, if the levy was I guess the question is, was the levy approved at the December 5th meeting?
Yes.
So there are two motions to approve the estimate and the actual levy. Right. So that is improper under Section 10-8 of the code.
10-8
or 1860? Or 10-60. I don't have it in front of me because my computer is not coming up right now. Hold on. Let me see if I can pull it back up.
Okay. Does that answer your question so we can move on while she gets you the numbers?
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
The levy that we're looking at is represents an increase to the operating levy of about $500,000. Am I saying that correctly?
Who was the question for?
Anybody that can answer.
Okay.
Finance director.
She can answer it. Finance director and Keith Freeman, you can answer his question. Can you repeat it? Let's hear it.
Does this vote represent approximating $500,000 increase to the operating levy in Section 1?
From which?
From last year's vote, sir.
Hold on.
And to be a little bit more, I'll share with you. Last year, the levy at $11,134,799. This year, the requested levy, $11,682,000.
That is correct. I have it. That's correct.
Okay, so then essentially we're asking that we raise taxes. Is that correct?
Are you asking me?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. With that, I have a superseding motion that I would like to add to request. My request is that we approve the ordinance at the level that was issued last year, the $11,134,799. Oh, that's my motion.
Have you considered cost of living? Have you considered inflation? Have you considered collective bargaining? Have you considered all of the things that people normally do when they pass tax levies?
Yes, sir. And I'll tell you where my confusion comes at.
Okay.
Unclear information being given to the board. My belief that there's overspending on things that are costing taxpayers money. So I think we need to work within what we have before asking the residents to pay more money out of their pocket for items that they didn't ask for. So yes, I considered that. And I believe at this time is not the proper time to request a tax increase. Additionally, not getting the information needed leaves me saying we need to, until we can learn to operate with what we've had and what we do, I do not want to ask another taxpayer for more money when we can't even get information distributed to the board. Again, forgive me, put on the website. We can't get information. The residents are really, really flying blind, as is the board. And we made no request to the residents. We didn't even put out there that a tax increase was being requested. That was not even put out there to have a discussion of, hey, taxpayers, we need to increase it, and here are the reasons. No discussion whatsoever with the community about, but we come in and ask for a tax increase. I think that's unfair, improper, and I think that we can stay within the bounds of what we have. So that's the reason for my
Just like you just didn't ask no questions about the budget. No clarification, no nothing, right? See what I'm saying? How y'all do? It's good for you to say that. Oh, okay, well, y'all should ask the people, y'all should this and y'all should that. Well, you know, just like I know, everybody raises their taxes by 4.99%. So y'all like to do this fictitious world of making videos, lying, saying the mayor want to raise your taxes. It's the mayor. Well, y'all know the mayor don't even vote, Trustee House. You know better, but you need to stop. Hold on. Let me finish my statement. You know better. You know everybody go up by 4.99%. But yeah, y'all made a video pointing the finger at me, right, Trustee Belcher, right? Stop it. You guys have been raising taxes since day one here. But yet y'all sit here and act like y'all don't, but y'all have. So you saying you don't raise taxes, Trustee House? You haven't raised taxes, no?
Yeah, my 7 years on the board, we have voted to raise taxes one time.
Oh, that's it? One time?
And it has not been in this administration. There are times we had offsetting, we increased the operating levy, decreased the debt service. Mm-hmm. Net effect was zero tax increase to the
oh, okay. Board, but you raised taxes one time. Okay. All right. Trustee Belcher, you too?
Yeah.
You too?
Oh, you want my response?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sure. So this is where I'm confused at, because we just had a vote that you sat there and went through all this stuff. So, oh, they cutting this, they cutting this, they cutting that. Then the next one, you want us to raise the taxes. I'm so confused right now, because if we didn't make those cuts, then this tax would have to take place to fund your luxurious lifestyle.
Okay,
right now.
Okay, pause.
You asked me to comment.
Go ahead.
I will not support a tax increase right now. That's why the budget, who y'all say, whoever helped us, who didn't help us or whatever, those items was cut for service. And it's funny how someone sits here and be like, oh, you know, this maintenance that we should think about that. We got $42,000 worth of lease payments of new cars. They better not need no maintenance right now. So it behooves me that you try to keep doing this back and forth, then keep with the old inflation. Everybody knows it's inflation, but everybody knows that when inflation comes, you know, there's a way of budgeting, cutting back on things, not sitting here and say, I'm going to still do what I want to do. I'm going to double it next month. Oh, taxpayers, give me y'all money. I'm not supporting it. Are you finished with me?
Are you done? I just want to make sure you're done so I don't interrupt you so you can hear me when I speak to you. Are you done, Trustee? Okay. So, as I always state, you guys put on this show. Y'all talk about what y'all ain't done, how y'all been at board meetings, and, oh, we never raised your taxes. It's the mayor. It's the mayor. It's not the mayor. It's the Board of Trustees. The Board of Trustees are the ones that vote on the tax levy. How dare you get up here and say that I want to raise taxes? Because that's not true. I don't even have a vote when it comes to raising your property taxes. Every single year, you guys raise the property taxes here in the Village of Dalton. Trustee House, Mr. Only voted one time. That's a lie. These are the lies that they tell. Like I keep telling y'all, every single time they lie about everything. And matter of fact, let me prove it. Let me show you. Play the tape. Please play the tape. Play the tape. In the back, play the tape. Just so you can see how these people right here lie. Y'all raised about 4.99%. And speaking of that, let me give you some more information before you play my tape. So you can see how people be lying. And I advise you to revisit your video you made, Trustee Belcher, because you want popularity. It's not going to work. Stop lying. I never raised anything. Keep my name out your mouth, because Mayor Hingard have not raised anything. But let me give you some things. 4.99%. Phoenix raised there. This for the year of 2023 to 2024, for those that don't understand how tax levies go. They can do it without going out to the public by 4.99%. Phoenix just did it. South Holland just did it. Lansing did it for 2.99%. Dixmoor did it for 4.99%. Calumet City did it for 4.99%. Thornton did it for 4.99%. Harvey did it for 5%. That's this year, today. So this is what I'm telling you why people don't pay attention. Everybody raises it 4.99% no matter what. Don't let them sit here because they need something to campaign on. Oh, guys, it wasn't us. We didn't do it. All right, watch this. Play the tape.
here, you understand what it used to be, what it turned out to be, and where we are today. So today, I'm going to take you down memory lane and explain to you all the nonsense that you see a couple people trying to keep up chaos in our village. First, I'm going to start with what tax levy is. Every year, we must levy taxes for our village. When we levy taxes, we get money to run our day-to-day operation. That's our police, our fire, our public works. All of those departments are levied by our taxes. So if we do not levy taxes, we will not receive the money to do the day-to-day operation, which is public service. So they made a video and sent it to a lot of residents stating that you're trying to increase your property taxes. In no way, shape, or form have I ever advocated to increase property taxes. As you know, as a trustee myself, I've always tried to decrease taxes, or if it's warranted, yes, you have to levy for taxes. But in this case, if you don't know, now you will know today, every community passes a tax levy of 4.99%, no matter what the public says, because that's the levy they can pass. If it's under 5%, you can pass it without going out to the public. When it goes above 5%, you must go to the public and let you guys know that. So if you go and you can FOIA anything I'm saying up here, you can FOIA any other towns, Harlan, Cayman City, Riverdale, Lansing, any town, and you'll see that they do the same thing. So that's what I'm going to show you today. I'm going to give you the facts. So I'm going to take you down memory lane by going to 2017. Can you play the tape?
Remember, trustee, I said he never raised y'all taxes. Let's pay attention to this. Liars. It's what the trustees don't want you to know about property taxes.
We was at $6 million, right, for levying taxes. If you look and read on that page right here, they increase your property tax by 14%.
Mm-hmm.
This is what you don't know, residents, 14%. So if you read and go a little farther, and you'll see who voted for basically increase your property taxes. On here, you'll see trustee Haps voted to increase your property taxes. Mm-hmm. And you'll see ex-trustee Stubbs voted to increase your property taxes. But I wanted to give you the order so you can understand who voted 14% to increase your taxes.
2017.
So when you're getting the information, you will have facts to go by. Then we'll go to 2018.
So who been raising our taxes?
$9 million. In here, if you look, same thing, taxes, trustees raised your taxes by 14% again.
Another 14%.
And that was, again, trustee House and trustee Stubbs. Mm-hmm. Of course, the rest of them voted as well.
Your name again, but you only raised taxes once.
All of them voted, but I'm putting two out because these are people that's on your board now that's trying to do spin cycle to tell you the opposite. Mm-hmm. So for years, they've been raising your taxes, 2018. Mm-hmm. Now let's move on. 2019, trying to do the same thing. But this time, this is when everybody voted for it. So this is $10 million, 2019. Mm-hmm. Trustee Brown, Trustee Tammy Brown voted for this. Trustee Holmes, Trustee House, Trustee Steves. Everybody voted for this, but it stayed the same. On May 2020, same difference. It stayed the exact same. 0%. That was for $10 million.
No increase. Yep. See, look at that number. 10,334.
Then if you go and you
go to the next year,
tell you who voted for in the lineup. Trustee Tommy Brown, Trustee Haps, and then Trustee Ed Steves.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm going to May of 2021. Tax levy for $10 million.
Yep.
On here it says again, 0%.
0% on the surface,
but
right?
When you read it, the people that voted for it, everybody voted for it.
Yep.
And that's what I wrote up there to raise your taxes, which was Trustee Steves, Trustee Norwood, Trustee Belcher, Trustee Tammy Brown, Trustee House. Everybody voted to raise your taxes, 2021.
You see how you
got copies of everything I got.
Keep going. Go ahead. Show them another year. Show them how to keep raising the taxes every year.
That's why I'm trying to say, right?
I told you don't come for me unless I sent for you. Go ahead.
Fact check, and then when you have proof yourself. Mm-hmm. 2022, levy taxes $27 million. Look, said again on the surface, 0%.
0%.
Again, I keep telling you, taxes go up 4.99% every year.
Every year.
People that voted for it, Trustee House, Trustee Norwood, Trustee Ed Steves. But guess what? Trustee Tammy Brown said no on this one time because it was election time. This is when y'all was voting for to make her a trustee. Mm-hmm. Belcher voted present. Mm-hmm. Why she vote present? President go with the majority. Either yes or you know. Why you vote present? Should have just said yeah or nay like you do any other time. I want to point that out. This is all the taxes up to date, 2022.
Yep.
Now the new tax levy that's being presented is the same concept. You have that one. I got crazy. Same concept. For $11 million. Mm-hmm. So say 0% on the surface, once again. And this one is the one that I'm saying we don't have a vote for yet, but people have to come to the board meeting. And then if you have a difference of opinion, it's what discussion is for, and you come and you have a happy medium. Because at the end of the day, we must provide services for our residents.
To show you an example, your tax is going up every single year. This board that keep claiming we didn't do it, it's the mayor. And it's a lie. The trustees vote to raise taxes, as you can see. Follow the money. Just because it says zero on the surface don't make it true. You have to follow the money. The money just showed you every year went up, even though it says zero, right? But it still increased by 4.99%. And in other years, they did it by 14%. Right? But so who lying? And we just talked to them. They all just lied about it. But you go make videos lying to people about it's the mayor. No, it's the trustees. Own up to the seats you sit in. You vote on things such as the tax levy, as you see.
Follow the money.
That's all you have to do is follow the money.
Don't it's want like. You to know. Is they have been raising your property taxes for years.
That part.
You must follow the money. As you can see, is proof of the Board of Trustees raising your property taxes.
Now keep up. So that's the point that I want to point out to y'all, that people gonna lie. They gonna make up stuff on you. When they can't control you, when they can't beat you, they gotta try to delude the residents to make them think you're doing something other than helping them. And that's what I just proved to y'all today. Every single time they put bad stuff on my name, I come back with facts, paperwork, and show y'all the truth. You see people, liars, they lie to y'all right here on the spot. Like, no, we ain't do that. And then I also told you, you gotta look at things just like how you go to for a contract. You know how they say, hey, make sure you read the fine print. Make sure you read the fine print, because we reading everything on the surface. It says zero, but we didn't go down to that dollar amount. That dollar amount increased by $300,000, $400,000. You follow the money. It's going to tell you the whole truth. As they say, women lie, men lie, numbers don't. It's in black and white, that part. So people can stop with all the spin cycles and all the mess. Miss me with that for this year, please. When you talk at least state facts. Everything I talk about, I have proof to back it up. Every single thing. So therefore, Tiffany, what you say, attorney? What we doing? Mm-hmm. I'm going to move forward. She got something to say.
I have two comments, man.
Yeah, you got your rebuttal. We fix your lie. It ain't going to work.
I really just want to know your official stance on this.
You ain't got to know my official nothing. You a trustee.
Are you advocating for an increase or are you not?
I just answered all your questions. You a trustee. You must do your job. Do what your conscience tell you. Don't be trying to get me to say something other than what you need to know. No, and I'm asking you, trustee, make a decision. You want to be the boss? It come with cost. Be the boss. Go ahead. Boss up and make a decision on what you want to do. You either for it or you not. Okay. Stop. Make a decision, right? Y'all make decisions when y'all have secret squirrel meetings, right? Y'all make decisions when y'all cut all this budget. Y'all made all them decisions, right? So make a decision. Stop trying to sit here and throw it back my way. Own up to it. So I keep telling people, everybody want to be the boss, but scared to own up to what it is because the public see you for who you are, which is a liar. Y'all lie to the public. Stop it and point at me. And it's you the entire time. Okay, Tiff, what we doing?
So under the, you know, in consideration of the mayor's veto, and since the veto was both to veto the estimate and the levy, because obviously when the veto was delivered, there was a bit of uncertainty as to what was approved at the December 5th meeting. So it'd be my recommendation to the board to amend this motion to make it in an approval of an estimate of a levy. And then you approve the estimate at this meeting, and then at the next board meeting, you guys approve the levy.
Okay, so my motion is to approve the estimate at the same rate on the operating levy as last year.
Second.
Is there a second?
Second.
All right. Please call the roll.
Aye.
Are you ready for that one, huh?
Aye. Trustee Stan Brown.
No.
Trustee Tammy Brown.
Aye.
Trustee House.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
No.
Trustee Belcher.
Aye.
Motion all right. Passed. Thank you guys for coming out. Can I have a motion to adjourn?
Motion.
Second.
Is there a second? It's been a motion and second. Please call the roll.
Trustee Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Stan Brown.
You know, aye. You got people running trustee your business Tammy like that.
Brown.
Aye. You got trustee no House. Financial aye. Background. Say it.
Trustee Holmes. Trustee Belcher.
Aye.
Meeting adjourned at 10:09 p.m.
All right. Thanks.